of 2016, ending more than a decade of military engagement triggered supposedly by the 9/11 attacks on the United States. The decision means that Obama will leave office in early 2017, having extricated the country's military from the longest war in U.S. history. He ended the combat presence in Iraq in 2011, though troops still remain on the ground there. Obama's White House Rose Garden announcement prompted criticism from Republicans that the hard-fought gains made against the Taliban could be lost in much the same way that sectarian violence returned to Iraq after the U.S. withdrawal. Obama, who made a whirlwind visit to U.S. troops in Afghanistan over the weekend before the American combat operations conclude at the end of 2014, appeared to anticipate concerns that he is abandoning Afghanistan. He said it is time for Afghans to secure their own country. Under his plan, 9,800 U.S. troops would remain behind into next year. By the end of 2015, that number would be reduced by roughly half. By the end of 2016, the U.S. presence would be cut to normal embassy presence with a security assistance office in Kabul, as was done in Iraq. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
From 1941, when an amoeba became the first single-celled organism to play professional baseball, to 1794, when Thomas Jefferson more than likely did something historically significant, The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 25, 1925, Tennessee teacher John T. Scopes was formally indicted for teaching the theory of evolution in a public school after a monkey called to the stand failed to turn into a human.
Sir, you have been on the witness stand for a full 3 hours now. And in this time, we haven't seen you lose any of your hair or shed your tail. Can you at least articulate a single justifiable reason why Mr. Darwin's theory should even be mentioned in our nation's classrooms?
And on May 27th, 1995, actor Christopher Reeve came in last place in a horseback riding event.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We are kicking off another episode here where you may take control of the airwaves. If you like, do it toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That is the Pro XPN toll-free line, 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Brett.
And Mark.
Brett's here courtesy of the School Sucks Project. We'll talk about that here a little bit more shortly. And, of course, take your calls at 855-450-FREE. Brett, you've been following the story of this psychopath who we discussed to some extent over the weekend here on Free Talk Live. The man who apparently stabbed his roommates to death, allegedly.
Yes.
And then also allegedly went on a shooting rampage to some extent, shooting multiple people in Santa Barbara, California.
Yeah, and, you know, it's interesting. So this happened on Friday, and during the day on Friday, I was actually in the process of recording a podcast for School Sucks on the topic of isolation. And then I took a break from that and went to the old news feed and started to hear about this story, and I realized this could turn into a much larger topic, and I paused. And, you know, I was hoping we could actually go through one of the articles that I was using together.
Sure.
It's from BBC Future, and it's called How Extreme Isolation Warps the Mind. And, you know, one of the reasons why I wanted to pursue this as a topic is sometimes I feel like I might isolate a little bit too much, you know?
That you yourself self-isolate?
Yeah, well, see, so there's a big difference between being antisocial, like Elliot Rodger is antisocial, and asocial, where I think sometimes you just prefer to be by yourself.
I mean, doesn't everybody at some point need to have some alone time?
Well,
I mean,
that's the thing. There's
humans
a balance.
Are very social animals in general. Like,
yeah.
If you don't have contact with others, it can be very bad, and I'm sure we're going to get into that. But at this, on the other hand, that does need to be balanced, right?
So, yeah, so one of the things that I try to be conscious of, and I talk a lot about it on my show in life, is balance, right? So we can certainly derive a lot of personal meaning from a certain pursuit or a certain activity, but it could, you know, be weighted down too heavily as far as the emotional financial time investment, you know. So people, one of the most common examples is being a workaholic, right? Mm-hmm. People who are deriving too much meaning in life from work, right? So the rest of the life is out of balance. So I'm somebody who works from home, mostly alone, where even though I'm interviewing people, there's very little eye contact. There's not so much face to face. And I started trying to just, you know, figure out how much time I was actually spending alone every week and why I spend time alone and how that might affect a man to spend that much time alone. So, I mean, I know you're pretty social. You're out a lot, and
but I'm also in a lot. I mean, I sit in here in this studio, and I happen to have Daryl come in to make phone calls with me in the morning.
Right,
but that didn't always occur. It used to be that was mostly me by myself. Of course, I'm talking to people on the phone, but again, not quite the same.
Yeah, yeah. How about you, Mark?
You
got the family at home all the time.
Yeah, but 3 months out of the year, the family's down in Florida.
Mm, okay.
And I sit at home alone, and oftentimes I'm trying to shoo them out of my office anyway. No, I can't help you with your little project, Laura. No, Jack, Daddy's on the phone. You know, that kind of thing. So I'm clawing for more alone time, it appears.
Well, but so let's go back a little further then, too. There are periods maybe in the past where you spent more time without positive social interactions?
I don't know what positive social interactions are, but
you know, ones that are you enjoy, that are, you know, beneficial.
No, not really. I mean, I've always been a social creature, and I sought people out. Less so now as I'm getting older, but in the past, I always did.
When I lived in Florida before I moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, I definitely didn't have as much socializing going on as I do today, or as I did as soon as I made the move to New Hampshire. But it didn't bother me. I wasn't unsatisfied or bummed out or depressed or anything like that. So I guess it doesn't, you know, that didn't get to me. I still had friends and I still had things that I did. I just have more of it now. I can do more.
Yeah, but see, I don't even think that isolation is necessarily tied to depression or low self-esteem. I mean, I look across all the areas of my life and I feel pretty good, you know, but I'm wondering if I am spending too much time alone, is there some negative psychological effect that we're not necessarily conscious of? You know, when you feel bad, right? I don't feel bad. I feel pretty darn good most of the time. But
I know when I don't exercise enough, I get kind of run down and yucky feeling.
Sure.
But I won't know that that's what's happening until long after I should have been exercised. You know what I mean? Like, I can really sort of get deep into it, into the periods when I should have been exercising. I was like, oh, yeah, this is because I haven't been exercising regularly. And I think that what you might be alluding to here is that you might, by being alone too long, you get in sort of a depressive cycle and not even realize that that's what's happening to you.
I can see that that would all be the case, but there seems to me to be a big difference between isolation and choosing alone time for oneself, or putting oneself into a circumstance where one should expect to be alone, you know, at a job, a solitary job, or whatever. Mm-hmm. Whereas if you are isolated from others without your consent, I think that's when the real problems of isolation, you know, come on. Because I can be as social as I would like to be. There's always things that anybody can, right? Like, there are always things you can do. You can go join a knitting club or something like that. There's something that you can do to go out and be social. Join a networking group. There are all kinds of things that can be done. But if you're forced into isolation without your consent, say if you're in jail and they put you in solitary confinement.
Yes.
That's, to me, true isolation, where you desire the interaction with others. But you can't have it.
Well, it's not that you just desire the interaction. You have to have it. As a human being, yes. There's a certain level of human contact you have to have. And if you don't get it, it's unhealthy and it's going to spiral downward pretty quickly. And solitary confinement in prisons, most people, maybe people don't know, prisons tend not to be solitary places at all.
Right. No, you usually have to break the rules in order to get put into solitary.
That was one of the things I wanted to ask about, because I'm wondering if that's a different type of isolation, where something that I don't think I've ever been in that situation. I mean, maybe here and there for short periods of time, where you're surrounded by other human beings, but there aren't any positive social interactions. Maybe it's not like that.
Are you
that
talking
way.
About being in general population in jail?
Yeah.
Oh, there were plenty of positive interactions.
I would think that there would be. Maybe it didn't feel that way at first. I don't know.
Now, I don't know what Mark's prison experience was like, but in jail in Cheshire County, it's almost like being at boys' camp. I mean, it's not so bad.
Yeah, a good boys' camp.
Yeah, they're not that good. I mean, some of these guys aren't good boys. But...
No, but I mean, like a fun, not a good boys' right. camp, but a quality, fun boys' camp. Like...
I wouldn't go that far with it. I wouldn't say quality, fun, but you could get positive experiences out of it.
You wouldn't pay $300 to spend a week there. No,
I know.
Okay.
No. All right. But there are jails where you can do that. Actually, I was reading prison legal news. Entirely unrelated at this point, but I was reading Prison Legal News, which is a great little publication you can get sent to yourself if you are in jail, and there was a story in there about these prisons for luxury people, like somewhere they will send Christian Slater, somebody who's got a lot of money. They can actually pay something like $100 a day in order to be in like an upgraded kind of capacity, where in some prisons they'll have access to an exercise bike, a laptop, a smartphone, for instance. Apparently these things actually exist. I don't think they exist in New Hampshire.
And none of the all really inconvenient sodomy thing that can go on with. And
yeah, you know,
people
believe
go on.
Larger cell, electricity. You know,
Goodfellas
like
jail, right? Goodfellas jail. You remember in Goodfellas how they were?
I not watched it.
Whoa. See Goodfellas. 1990, directed by Martin Scorsese, rated R. So they're all in jail. They're all mobsters, but they're connected. So they're all in jail together, and they've got like wine and bread. And
oh yeah.
So that's Goodfellas jail.
I almost feel like these those stories really do a disservice to people who are in jail today, because, you know, I was in jail and had some wine and some bread, but I brewed my wine with
potato skins, with
juice that I've bought in the canteen.
Let's come back and we'll talk about isolation on the way. You can share your experience at 855-450-FREE.
Some clubs are pricey.
$25 for a cheeseburger?
Some are exclusive.
My family came over on the Mayflower.
And some are snooty.
Is she wearing white after Labor Day?
But America's Best Value Wins Value Club is just right for everyone who wants to save instantly. Value Club members get 15% off, room upgrade, and late checkout when available at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Go to americasbestvaluein.com and sign up today.
Now that's better.
You know Lumber Liquidators for having the best selection of flooring at the lowest prices. And right now, you can buy one floor and get 50% off another on their thickest and best Dream Home laminates. No games, no gimmicks, just huge savings off already ridiculously low prices. Plus, get great deals on pre-finished hardwood and Morningstar bamboo. So go to LumberLiquidators.com to find the store nearest you. Special financing is available. But hurry, this buy one, get one sale ends Tuesday, June 3rd.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Want to lose weight? Listen up, because an incredibly effective weight loss supplement is being given out to 100 callers right now. Because it's so potent, please take no more than one capsule a day. Be one of the first 100 callers to get a risk-free trial. 1-800-968-9269. Supplies are limited because this product is proven and can cause dramatic weight loss. It's called AF Plus. Take one capsule just once a day as directed, and you can experience maximum weight loss. Pounds in days. It's all natural, safe, and healthy. But if your weight loss with AF Plus is too dramatic, please decrease use and only take it every other day. Only 100 callers are guaranteed to get a risk-free trial. Call 1-800-968-9269. Mayo Clinic research proves that carrying fat in your midsection raises your risk of heart disease, stroke, high blood pressure, even cancer. If you need to lose weight, you absolutely must call now. 1-800-968-9269. 1-800-968-9269.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Bring up anything here. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us on Skype. Have you had experience with isolation and what the effects are of that? They are not very good. We're going to get into the discussion in more detail here with Brett from the School Sucks Project. And again, don't forget you can join us online at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you on the website completely free. So enjoy all of those. Again, freetalklive.com. So blockchain.info, great website to go and get your own Bitcoin wallet, your own personal Bitcoin wallet, which is really handy and works great on an Android device. They've got an app for Android. If you don't have Android, if you're using a laptop or an iPhone or something like that, you can just use their website, and they've got a great web wallet as well. It makes it really easy. Blockchain's got something new. It's a merchant wallet, which means that when it's installed on your favorite Android device, you go into this new merchant wallet. You can receive money with the merchant wallet, but your employees will not be able to send money with the merchant wallet, which is that's a pretty important feature when you're talking. I'm sorry, you know, yes, you want to trust all your employees. I get that. But the truth is, most of the heists in business are done by employees. So it's just not a good idea to allow your employees access to your bank account. And so that's one of the things that the merchant wallet doesn't do.
Good fences make for good neighbors.
Yeah. And in addition to that, if you've ever tried to get any kind of merchant services as a business owner before, you know how big of a hassle it can be. You've got to apply, you've got to be approved, you've got to jump through all kinds of hoops. There's agreements, there's terms of service, there's liability. Not with blockchain.com. You just go and download the app. There's no terms of service, there's no ID requirements. They don't even care who you are. You just go and download the app and start using it, and there's zero fees on top of that. So check it out at blockchain.com. So, Brett, let's jump into the story here about the isolation.
Yeah, you actually had a good segue when you were talking about forced isolation, right? Like from being in jail, because
right.
That's...
to me, that's real isolation. If you are... Was it Thoreau who went and shut himself off in the woods? He went away for a while?
As I understand it, when his clothes got dirty, we went back to mom's house, and that he'd go sometimes off into town to get meals and that
he
kind
would,
of thing.
He would, huh? But, okay, so he did have interaction with people there.
Yeah, like I'm thinking that, you know, the pitch behind Walden is mm-hmm. that he went off into the woods. However,
not so much.
He didn't get that far.
Yeah. So, but I think the people who isolate themselves.
Lots of vigorous walks into town.
People who isolate themselves for short periods of time, I don't think that would be as damaging because then you've chosen to do it to yourself.
Sure. But, I mean, I still think, I don't want to call it consequences, but there's definitely effects of doing that. Like, mm-hmm. I realized, I think it was back in.
You might be more likely to walk around naked, for instance.
Absolutely. Yeah. And then you just have to remember when you go out that door.
I'll need pants.
If you're going into town, you can't walk there naked.
Grab those pants.
Actually, you could if you were in Brattleboro or Vermont, for instance. Actually, I think Brattleboro had a town ordinance against it. But in Vermont, you can walk around completely naked from most places to most places in Vermont.
This is not legal advice.
So I'll be a little revealing here with my pants on. Mm-hmm. There was a time back in December when I realized I hadn't talked to anybody in like 4 days.
Mm.
I hadn't talked to another person, and it wasn't even like a thing that I was conscious of. I just hadn't. I was by myself, staying by myself, hadn't talked to a soul in 4 days. And I think when people have these long periods of isolation, voluntary or otherwise, it was totally voluntary. I mean, I could always, you know, pick up the phone or get on Skype and do as close to face-to-face as possible with a friend far away. You start to act bizarre.
You start to say things out loud.
Yes, you do. Sounds like
this happens for other people when they are 4 days separated from people.
I'm glad we're having this conversation, okay? Because then also, if you're not being social like the three of us are right now, and there's plenty of people listening to us as well, if we're not getting this out there, then you start to say, well, gosh, I'm really weird. There might be something wrong with me. I talked to myself all day, and I said some pretty strange things.
I think it must be odd if somebody, like, caught me, you know, just happened to be around when I start talking to myself, because I'll just have an outburst.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Me too. I've been caught. So now we're connecting. We're identifying. We're face-to-face, eye contact, the three of us, and this is very healthy. But if this goes on and on and on, you start to get, well, a little crazy. You start to feel a little crazy, right?
Well, other people can be grounding, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I forget who it was, a comedian years ago, says living alone is dangerous because there's nobody there to say, hey, man, why are you doing that?
Right.
That's weird. That's a really weird thing that you're doing. So, I think we need...
Well, I don't think, this whole idea of living alone is rather unique to the North American continent. The idea that you're somehow supposed to have your own place with your own toilet and your own bed and you know, your own door and all that stuff. It's nice to have a room, certainly, but everywhere else in the world, humans live with other humans. And usually they're in family units, no doubt. Why shouldn't people that love each other live in the same, same building? But I think this problem we're talking about might be uniquely American.
That's actually a really interesting point, and this is one of the things that I've learned from my conversations with the historian that I always mention on the show. We're doing a history series right now, and he talks about the nuclear family, right? As a Puritan American kind of thing, right? That here the phrase he used was people, husband and wife, with the children, raising the family on an island, and not a literal island, but a sort of financial and social island, that we live in this unit by ourselves. Well, immigrants were often criticized for, like, oh my goodness, there's so many of them.
Yeah, they're rolling in with grandma and in tow, you know, and the whole thing. Well, thank goodness, because
it's smart.
People say it takes a village or whatever to raise kids, and I don't think that's an entirely untrue statement, because I don't think that a couple is really cut out for raising kids. I mean, my wife has one child, no. Real job, as it were. I don't know what terminology to use in this circumstance.
Well, hold on a second. I mean, she works for you. She works with you, and she's busy.
Maybe 2 hours a week she puts in on Free Talk Live. The rest of the time she's, doing food in the garden and taking care of the kid and whatever errands she has to run and that kind of thing. So,
and when you say real job, and maybe I'm trying to soften the blow of the trouble that you would get in if I was your wife and I heard you say that, real job, like you get in a car at 7:45 because you have to be somewhere at 8:15 and you answer to a boss and you sit at a desk and you get a paycheck on Friday through direct deposit and you have health insurance. Like, maybe that's real job.
Even less than that, she could have her own home business that she runs, but she doesn't have a money generating job, I guess.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. I get what you're saying. So, I think that is something that might be uniquely American, because we're all supposed to be in these little boxes, so to speak, you know, next to each other. And you can wave and you can admire Jim's lawn, mm-hmm. but you're not really a community like I think communities once existed in this country and in other cultures. And
yeah,
that's true. Yeah, I think that community is going away. Like, I've had neighbors that I've lived in very, very close proximity to, like in condos and stuff, didn't even know their names.
Wow. You know, that was definitely true for me in Florida. Here, I at least know the names of most of my neighbors.
Yes.
It's a little bit better here, I think, but still, it's easy to be disconnected. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The effects of isolation. We continue.
Gentlemen, in search of a million-dollar smile that'll make them take notice, I mean really get their attention, then get the mud. My Magic Mud. The fluoride-free whitener with no chemicals, additives, GMOs, or bad taste. And safe to swallow. My Magic Mud detoxifies, reduces sensitivity, cleans and strengthens your teeth while it whitens. Comes as a powder for pure whitening power. Start looking good for that special someone. Get the mud now. MyMagicMud.com.
Tired of taking handfuls of vitamin pills? Look and feel super with a great-tasting liquid vitamin and mineral supplement called Passion 4 Life. This incredible 1-ounce daily drink can lead to better stamina and energy due to faster, more complete absorption. Passion 4 Life contains 135 all-natural whole food ingredients. It's the best-tasting, most powerful product of its kind on the market. Order now by calling 844-TRY-LIFE or find out much more about Passion for Life by visiting 844-TRY-LIFE.com. 844-TRY-LIFE.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc, and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Imagine for a moment a radio program, the most personal of mediums, that reaches hundreds of thousands of people on more than 140 radio stations across the U.S. and around the world through the internet with podcasts and live streams. Imagine the advertising is affordable, from $600 to $6,000 a month. Free Talk Live is that program. We will work with you to get clicks, calls, views, or sales. Email me at mark@freetalklive.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. Bring up whatever you want here, toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. And please, if you have an experience with isolation, whether it was self-imposed or whether it was imposed upon you without your consent, that's what we've been discussing so far this hour. Brent, you have a story, and I haven't asked you yet. What is the source of your story about the isolation that we have yet to really dig into?
Sure. It comes from the website BBC Future.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So British Broadcasting Company. And this is the future section of their website. It's called How Extreme Isolation Warps the Mind.
We are going to get into that in just one moment. But first,
Dodd-Frank, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, they're all killing the mortgage industry. But the mortgage minute guy, Roger Schlesinger, has found some ways around these rules and organizations. Private loan sellers are competing directly against the U.S. government, and things look pretty good. Stated income loans are back. These really weren't the problem with the mortgage crisis anyway. So go state your income, truthfully, obviously, and get a loan. Rates are great. It's never been easier to get a loan. If you need to refinance or get cash out, call the Mortgage Minute Guy. It's mortgageminuteguy.com. 1-866-288-0088. MortgageMinuteGuy.com. 1-866-288-0088.
So let's jump into it, shall we?
Yeah, I like this because it takes a scientific angle with this topic, and I think it's important. Like, we can all imagine why this could be bad, and we talked about maybe some of the funny, weird things that we do. But there are obviously more serious consequences for more extreme situations people mm-hmm. might find themselves in. So it begins. When people are isolated from human contact, their mind can do some truly bizarre things, says Michael Bond. Why does this happen? Sarah Shord's mind began to slip after about 2 months into her incarceration. She heard phantom footsteps and flashing lights, and spent most of her day crouched on all fours, listening through a gap in the door. That summer, the 32-year-old had been hiking with two friends in the mountains of Iraqi Kurdistan when they were arrested by Iranian troops after straying onto the border with Iran.
Hmm.
Accused of spying, they were kept in solitary confinement in...
Because spies are busy, testing out your rocky trails on the border.
Well... Yeah, you're right.
It's dumb.
It's dumb. It's yeah, it's very political. You were right. They are used as props, I think, in these situations.
Yeah, I think that's exactly what they are. I mean, the United States should grab Canadians that wander across the border and say, "You're spying!" Hold them for ransom or something. That's going to make for good international relations. Look, I'm no fan of the way Iran's treated in international politics, but crap like this certainly doesn't help.
Sure, sure. Accused of spying, they were kept in solitary confinement in Evin prison. Now that's Evin, E-V-I-N, the name of the prison in Tehran, each in their own tiny cell. She endured almost 10,000 hours with little human contact before she was freed.
Hmm.
10,000 hours. That's 2/3 of a public school education, by the way, in hours.
Jeez.
That's quite a chunk of time. One of the most disturbing effects was the hallucinations.
10,000 hours divided by 24 is 416 days.
Yeah.
So it makes you wonder, what would they lose out on, the imprisoners? And this...
What would they
lose out on by letting people just be in cells together? Really? What's the problem? Why couldn't you put a few people together?
Well, because you want somebody to go crazy. I mean, when you put somebody
right,
into isolation, you
it's
know
psychopathy.
The effects. Right, the people who run these prisons, it's not like they're ignorant to the effects of isolation on human beings. They fully are aware
of how significant this is.
I never thought I'd say this, but in defense of the Iranian secret police or whatever, you know, maybe they really thought that. Now, I know this sounds silly and political, but maybe the people tasked with running the prison or watching them really believed that they were spies, regardless of what the Iranian government's agenda was. Mm-hmm. So when you're dealing with people that you think are spies and you're just, you know, the person on the floor in the prison, your job is to break the spy.
Here's a little clue for the people that want to break spies around the world. Put somebody in the cell that's in fact a Confederate.
Yeah, and get them to talk.
Get them to talk. Get it recorded. Put recording devices in the cell so that the conversations are recorded and they're on audio for everyone to hear.
By the way, this is a tactic that the police have used in the past. And if you're in a jail cell and someone comes in and starts asking you questions, probably be a good idea to not give them information.
It's an expensive tactic, though. Mm-hmm. I mean, consider for a second the level of commitment that you would have
as an agent, you mean?
As an agent of whatever, to go in and spend a week, a month, many months in a prison. I mean, that's a high level of commitment.
True.
That level of commitment generally is going to be rewarded with a commensurate amount of money. And so this tactic is really only going to be employed in circumstances where they actually believe they have a spy and not some American that they're torturing the crap out of.
Now, remember, it can also be cheap, though, too, because you have maybe in a general population or somewhat general population, you have a bunch of guys who, in many cases, are probably looking for lesser
sentences.
Right,
that's a good point.
If you have recorded devices, now, I don't trust a convict to just say,
no, that was my third example. That was my third example, is it's also very inaccurate. So there was
Hold on. In the jail I was in, there's a recording speaker and microphone in every single cell. So those the agents in the control room, if they want to turn on your cell and listen in on whatever conversation you're having and record it, that's a matter of a few button presses for them.
Right.
No problem.
Crazy. So
this was the story with Ramzi Youssef, who was allegedly the mastermind of the 1993 World Trade Center bombing. Supposedly, there was a mobster who was in very close proximity, either in the same cell or the cell next to him.
Is this the guy that's blind, the blind sheik?
No. He was just a mobster.
Okay.
Ramzi Youssef. The blind sheik is...
you don't need to know his name.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay. I forget it. But that's somebody else. So they said that was how they wound up getting a bunch of information about Ramzi Youssef. Mm-hmm. But you also have to think that they want information about somebody like Ramzi Youssef. So they might be more willing to, take or kind of take at face value false information from somebody trying to lower their sentence. In fact, not to go onto a complete tangent here, but most of what we were told about Osama bin Laden was, delivered to the district attorney's office in Manhattan by a guy who was on the run from bin Laden because he owed him money.
Hmm.
And they wanted to use RICO, the racketeering statute that they used to go after organized crime against bin Laden. And in order to do that, they had to prove that he was the head of an organization. And this guy who was on the run from bin Laden and trying to dodge some legal matters of his own, help them kind of concoct this story about Osama bin Laden being the mastermind of a James Bond villain terrorist organization, which may or may not exist, but that's a topic for another time.
Didn't seem like it. I mean, Al-Qaeda seemed to do just fine without bin Laden in charge. We were told he's in charge all the time, and,
Well, terrorism seemed to do just fine, and the question is whether or not Al-Qaeda was real, but that is certainly very unrelated to the matter at hand here, so I can continue.
Please.
So it's quoting Shord, the woman who was captured. In the periphery of my vision, I began to see flashing lights, only to jerk my head around and find that nothing was there, she wrote in the New York Times in 2011. At one point, I heard someone screaming, and it wasn't until I felt the hands of one of the friendlier guards on my face trying to revive me that I realized the screams were my own. We all want to be alone from time to time to escape the demands of our colleagues or the hassle of crowds, but not alone. For people, prolonged social isolation is all bad, particularly mentally. We know this not only from reports by people like Shord, who experienced it firsthand, but also from psychological experiments on the effects of isolation and sensory deprivation, some of which had to be called off due to extreme and bizarre reactions of those involved.
Yes, like the Stanford Prison Experiment. We'll come back with more here in moments, and you can share your thoughts, any observations, experiences you have with isolation. We'll continue the discussion. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. What if humans found a habitable planet, set up housekeeping, and then got left alone by Earth and its big government? Well, that happened in Freehold, Michael Z. Williamson's seminal work. Now available for the first time in a signed, limited hardback edition. Other books in this series are also available in paperback. I cannot recommend a modern fiction work more highly than Freehold. Earth might have left Freehold alone, but it doesn't stay that way. It's war. Get your copy right now at all major booksellers and shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey everyone, have you heard about the no-no hair removal device that's sweeping the globe? If you want to go weeks without shaving and get smooth, professional, quality results, here's our favorite host, Cheryl, for no-no hair removal.
Thanks. Hey gals, I love talking about my no-no. It's this cute little hair removal system that you can take with you and use almost anywhere at home or on the road. No more expensive in-office treatments, painful waxing, and no more wasting your valuable time. Got unwanted facial hair? No-no has patented Thermacon technology that works on all hair and skin colors, so it's perfect for using on all body parts. And now you can take advantage of this incredible risk-free trial. Get the No-No, the facial kit, a travel case, and a $100 discount shopping card, and you don't risk a penny to try it. Try the incredible No-No hair completely risk-free. Call 1-800-953-6062. That's 800-953-6062. 800-953-6062.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, Rich Paul is our first announced keynote speaker, and more are being announced now at keenvention.info. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through Porkfest, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live.
You can bring up anything you want. Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE. That's brought to you by ProXPN, by the way. That's 855-450-3733. Speaking of ProXPN, what is it? It is a global virtual private network, and you can go and get started for free. You go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you can just grab their software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices as well. If you're a Linux user, you will need to contact their support department. They'll send you some info on how to get it working. It's actually pretty simple. It's just not on their website. You just have to ask them. proxpn.com/FTL. Go and get started, and then when you're ready, move up to the premium account, because with their free account, you don't get the unlimited bandwidth. With the premium account, not only do you get unlimited bandwidth, but you also get servers around the world to which you can connect. You can privately torrent with their premium account. They help protect you by encrypting your data connection, meaning that your internet service provider cannot know what you're doing as soon as you start using ProXPN. If you're not using ProXPN right now, your ISP is likely snooping on you. They likely know every single website that you're visiting and every search term that you enter, and they're probably logging it for up to 5 years. You can stop that from happening right now by going to proxpn.com/FTL and getting started. When you're ready to upgrade to the premium account, use our discount code FTL20 and you'll get 20% off for the lifetime of your account. And if you use that FTL20 code on the annual plan, it breaks the price down to $5 per month. Great deal and great privacy protection. There's also a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep online records of your habits or offline records. They don't keep any records of your online habits at proxpn.com/FTL. So let's go to the phones here. We'll talk more about isolation and its effects here in a moment, because we still have just kind of, even though we've spent the whole hour on it, we've kind of barely scratched the surface. Ty, you're on the line in Tennessee, though, and what's on your mind tonight? Ty in Tennessee, going once. Actually, he's muted. Now I can. Go ahead.
Hey, I was calling because I was listening on the listen lines and heard Brett, and it just reminded me of a conversation that's been going on Facebook based upon one of the School Sucks podcast Q&A episodes with Thaddeus Russell.
Yeah.
Where he was talking about the non-aggression principle, and I guess he had never heard of it before he went to one of the deals up there in New Hampshire.
Liberty Forum. But, yeah, he spoke there, Liberty, I think, last year, and somebody asked him about it after he spoke. Yeah.
What is the non-aggression principle before we go on with this conversation?
Ty,
well, the non-aggression principle is basically a moral foundation for, I guess, what we'd call the American brand of libertarianism, that says that aggression, initiation of physical force, is wrong, whether it's against a person or their property. So it's a moral foundation for social interactions.
Sounds right.
All right. So what about it?
Well, the way the discussion was going with Thaddeus Russell, he was basically talking about a libertarianism, I think, that doesn't need it, that he thinks that the non-aggression principle is superfluous, that really all you need is self-interest, and that, like I said, that the non-aggression principle is superfluous. And I was just wondering what Brett's thoughts might be on this.
Is that, Brett, just to recap, is his recap appropriate to what Thaddeus said? Obviously, Thaddeus isn't here to...
Yeah, I think it is. And you know, I'm not terribly well-versed. I would think that the go-to source for really trying to understand the connection between, you know, the logic of this and the morality of this would be something like The Ethics of Liberty by Murray Rothbard, which I have not read. I'm somewhat familiar, or I was at one point in the past more familiar with the arguments in that book. But I think that it is obviously preferable from just a self-interest point of view to not aggress against other people, because sooner or later that fails. Sooner or later, that's not going
to
work.
Well, hold on. It seems to work pretty well for the politicians.
Ah, but that's because. But all right. So yeah, let's add some detail. With this mythology that's superimposed on society, yeah, as long as that mythology is there, it works very well.
Meaning
so,
that they should be obeyed and
right,
observed.
Right.
Well, that somehow they're superior, or yeah, they're are representatives,
smarter,
or whatever.
Yeah.
So if I could superimpose that kind of mythology on even just, say, a neighborhood, like I could get everybody in a neighborhood to believe that I have the best ideas for education. So when I show up at their door with a bag for them to put their money in and a gun in the other hand just in case, they're like, oh, well, yes, it's for the kids. You know, if I could superimpose that mythology on people, but I can't because I don't control the schools. I don't have, you know, access and control over the channels of information like the state does and like the state has had for a long time. So without that mythology, it wouldn't work because people would be like, and it's the point we make all the time. Who are you, TSA agent? Who are you, cop, to think you're just a human being trying to aggress against another human being? You know, your badges don't grant extra rights and all that. So, but because of that mythology, they're easily able to get away with that.
Yeah, I think that there seems to be a particular brand of, I think, left libertarianism in the U.S. that's of this idea that the self-interest is all that's needed and that the non-aggression principle actually is superfluous or has holes in it or something like that.
Yeah, the other part of the other part of Thaddeus Russell's left libertarianism is that he's making a historical argument that all property rights, historically anyway, are enforced by the state, right? So he wouldn't see, it's hard for him to see how property would work in a completely voluntary society.
I would further say that that self-interest is, I agree that self-interest is all that's needed. However, that doesn't explain things to people. And we're trying to explain things to people in a way they can grok it.
Absolutely.
You know, there was a study that I talked about on air here that 4% of people believe that they are in the 50 percentile below average in intelligence, which is to say that 46% of people who are dumber than average believe that they are in fact not. So you have to explain things in a way that people can understand them easily. Self-interest says, well, I guess I should do whatever the hell I want to do, to somebody who doesn't take the time to consider that, you know, you need to treat people the way you want to be treated if you want to be treated well, and that kind of thing. So when you give the non-aggression principle, it's easy. It's one sentence that you don't aggress against people for political or social gain. And really, it can just be brought down to you should not initiate force. Force is stealing or hurting people or committing fraud against them.
And after you make that argument – sorry, Ty, one more thing real quick. And after you make that argument to a statist, you're really just doing grief counseling after that, right? Because you've won the moral argument. And they know it more often than not. And that's one of the things why one of the reasons why the non-aggression principle is so valuable, because it exposes the state. And I think that's part of what you're saying, right?
Yeah.
So that's the value, I think, is that it's a great teaching tool and it's a great persuasive tool for us.
Yeah, nobody argues the non-aggression principle when you say it.
Right.
It's when you apply it to the crap they think that then, oh my God, wait.
Yeah, right.
And I think therein lies the problem. And I think this is where the left libertarian critique of the non-aggression principle holds water, is it's hard to find a good definition of what really constitutes aggression. Such as another example, using Thaddeus Russell at that Liberty Forum, the deal was that they were smoking weed at the hotel, and that was against the rules, so they violated the property rights of the hotel. Well, that's not really an act of aggression, because there's no harm done. There's no damage done to property. There's no physical damage done to any individual. The people that own the hotel are free to kick them out for smoking weed there and violating their rules, but it's not really an act of aggression to smoke weed against their rules.
Well, I think there are plenty of valid critiques of the non-aggression principle, and I think the number one critique from my perspective is it doesn't go far enough to describe how people should interact with one another. It's just a baseline starting point.
It's a baseline starting point. And
that's it.
And one of the really great things about the non-aggression principle is it gets people talking about sort of the chinks in the armor. If you need a principle that's so ironclad that you can't find anything wrong with it in order to live your life, your life is really messed up.
Right, but like I said, I think I think the real big problem is defining what really constitutes aggression. And I think that, to me anyway, that dividing line has to be there is really harm done. Physical harm done to a person or to property.
I tend to agree with that. And thank you for the call, Ty. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. You know, the non-aggression principle doesn't prohibit people from being jerks to one another.
Sure.
Doesn't prohibit racism or bigotry or anything else that, you know, I find despicable. So I think it doesn't go far enough. 855 453. Hour 2's next.
There's a treasure hunt going on at mathgate.info, a Bitcoin treasure hunt. You can find Bitcoins by proving theorems. So, learn some logic, do some math, find some Bitcoins. Even better, mathgate.info is designed to be used anonymously. So, connect to mathgate.info through Tor, prove some theorems, find some anonymous Bitcoins. Don't wait, others are already searching for the Bitcoins. Go to mathgate.info today and join the treasure hunt. There are anonymous Bitcoins to be had for the taking at mathgate.info.
This is the Central Scrutinizer. I steal your labor by force through taxation.
My job is to spy on you and keep you from hearing things like the Freedom Fiends. I especially do not want you to torrent
Freedom Fiends episodes to keep them drone-proof. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Juicy Juice, 100% juice, providing a full serving of fruit in every 4 ounces. Visit us at juicyjuice.com. When it comes to nutrition, kids need both fruits and vegetables every day to stay healthy and grow. For the ideal mix, your kid should have at least 1.5 cups of any veggie or 100% veggie juice and 1 cup of any fruit or 100% fruit juice a day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, May 28, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,264, silver opened at $19.03, and Bitcoin is trading at $568. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Free the Market, Free Ross Ulbricht, a community fundraiser being held this Saturday from 6 until 9 at Brave New Books in Austin. Join special guest Cody Wilson of Defense Distributed. Proceeds go to the Ross Ulbricht Legal Defense Fund. That's this Saturday, May 31st, 6 until 9 at Brave New Books in Austin. Support also comes from GrowYourOwnGroceries.org, now offering an 8-week course where you can learn to treat the most common family ailments with simple medicines that you can grow or easily find. Learn more at GrowYourOwnGroceries.org. And support comes from Bitmain Tech, creators of the newly released Antminer S2 Bitcoin Miner. 1 terahash, only 1,000 watts. Order yours online today at bitmaintech.com or call them up, 844-BITMAIN. That's 844-248-6246. In the news, on Tuesday, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency met with concerned mothers, scientists, and environmentalists to discuss concerns over Monsanto's Roundup being found in breast milk. Moms Across America helped organize a phone blitz of the EPA, and founder Zin Honeycutt called attention to numerous studies that show serious harm to mammals. Roundup was created by Monsanto in the 1970s. The main ingredient is glyphosate. Neil Anderson of the EPA's Pesticide Reevaluation Division stated that over 100 studies have been reviewed, and a decision on glyphosate safety will be made by 2015. According to documents released to the New York Times, the Department of Homeland Security and its intelligence sharing fusion centers relied heavily on social media for monitoring the activities of Occupy Wall Street activists around the nation. Around 4,000 pages of unclassified emails and reports from 2011 and 2012 were released through Freedom of Information requests. A week ago, the U.S. charged 5 Chinese military officers with hacking, which the country has not only objected to, but is now firing back.
Referencing documents released by whistleblower Edward Snowden, the Chinese government says they are the target of U.S. cyber spying, and they want it to stop. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Affordable Sound, CD and DVD duplication, along with posters and promotions materials. Mention promo code Liberty when you order 10 or more posters, and you get 10 free. Online, affordablesound.com, or call them up at 512-459-5253. That's affordablesound.com. And support comes from Voice and Exit, maximizing human flourishing through radical innovation. Tickets on sale now. Get 10% off with promo code FREEDOM. June 21st at Austin Music Hall. Get yours at voiceandexit.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, May 28th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Washington State's Department of Corrections will soon allow parolees to smoke marijuana. According to King 5 News, the change in policy takes effect June 1st and will allow the state's 14,000 parolees to consume marijuana just like any other Washington State citizen. The Department of Corrections insists it's not endorsing the use of marijuana, but is only upholding the legalization law passed by voters in 2012. On May 14th, speaking from an undisclosed location in the mountains on the southern Philippine island of Mindanao, a group of Filipino indigenous elders spoke about resisting timber and mineral interests. The elders stated that if the military takes away their land, they will fight with their native weapons. They are calling on the Philippine government to demilitarize their lands and respect the Manobo indigenous people's territorial rights. The group of elders is being led by Datu Apoga, a well-known fugitive who led indigenous resistance in 1994, fighting corporate security with bows and arrows and spears. Overnight Monday, a hacker gained access to numerous iPhones and iPad owners' devices in Australia. The targets awoke to a message on their screen that read, "Device hacked by Oleg Pliss," and demanded a ransom of $50 to $100 in order to unlock it. Reports say users were affected in Queensland, New South Wales, Western Australia, Victoria, and even in New Zealand. Users with passcodes were able to restore their devices through iTunes. However, hackers created passcodes for users without one, making it more difficult to regain access to their electronics. Apple has not yet commented. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from The Corey Moore Show, live Friday nights, 9 o'clock Central, at CoreyMooreShow.com. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated. Precious metals at reasonable rates since 1977. Online at rrbi.co. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, May 28th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
For over 12 years, Halverson Enterprises CEO Peter Weathers has taken a hands-on approach in all aspects of the tech firm's growth and day-to-day business. But employees say the executive's true talent lies in his unique ability to recognize great ideas and then absolutely ruin them.
For as long as I've worked here, Peter has been able to sit down in a meeting, listen to a million different ideas, pick out the one that makes the most sense creatively and financially, and then totally destroy it until there's basically nothing worthwhile about it left. He's remarkable.
Employees throughout the company say they're most impressed by Weathers' ability to water down promising ideas with meaningless jargon, consistently choose the wrong person to head up every project, and inject virtually every halfway decent thought with his own short-sighted and terrible insights.
At our all-hands meeting the other week, our team put forth a very feasible plan to boost productivity. And it was really incredible to see Peter's mind at work, just taking every good aspect of our proposal and dismantling it like a small child.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, we're launching into the second hour here. You may take control toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You may Skype into the show. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio this evening, it's Ian.
Brett.
And Mark.
We've been talking about isolation. We're going to continue that discussion here. What does it do to the mind?
Right.
We will get into that. Also, your calls, experiences are certainly welcome. We're going to start things out this hour by going to Liberty Phoenix in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live via Skype.
Hey, guys. I'm really glad to see you started today with isolation, because I've kind of had my own self-imposed isolation over the last 2 days. Over the last, I want to say 4 weeks, it seems like every 2 days that I have off, I've completely isolated myself. I think it stems mainly the guilt and the fear that I feel as far as dealing with my ex getting married that's coming up in like 2 weeks.
So you feel guilty and fearful because somebody that you used to be with has found somebody else?
I never once wanted to say that it had any rational sense, but I mean, yeah, I mean, there, I have a lot of fear of just being alone, which of course makes me more standoffish and more uncomfortable around people. Like just earlier today, I spent the last 2 days completely isolated downstairs in my basement, and I went over to see my kids earlier, and it was such an uncomfortable feeling.
Kids that you have with this ex?
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yeah, we were all over at my ex's sister's house and hanging out with all of my children were hanging out with their cousins and so forth. So it was a very odd feeling, you know, just considering the fact that I not only isolate myself because of my fear of being alone and my issues with her getting married soon, but also the fact that none of these other people have any concept of how they own themselves, and it completely ruins any interpersonal relationships that I've had with them because I have no qualms of calling them. I'm a self-admitted brutalist. I have no qualms with calling.
You're a self-admitted what? Brutalist? I'm sorry. Your connection tonight isn't so hot, and it's not impossible to understand what you're saying most of the time, but every now and then it becomes a little warbly.
What I'm guessing, if you're on Skype, check your microphone. It might be connected to the wrong. It sounds like a built-in microphone versus the good mic you're usually on.
I thought that might be it.
Well, now is not the time for technical support.
Yeah, not really that. But yeah, I mean, the isolation, it stems mainly just from, I think, fear and guilt that people have. That's why they self-isolate themselves.
Well, you know, I had a situation recently that helps me identify with what you're saying. And I think it's interesting because obviously when times are tough, finding the right people to be around can be really helpful, you know, just to be able to bounce that off somebody else and get some feedback and get some empathy. My situation was totally different, but I also found myself isolating recently. I had to go in for like a medical procedure where I was knocked out, which was very scary. And in the days leading up to that, and also thinking I was going to find out potentially that something was very wrong with me, I didn't want to talk to anyone. Like any kind of interaction with another person seemed like it would be a burden. But what I also realized is I felt like I would have been a burden on them. You know, like all I could bring to it was my fear and anxiety about what was going on. And
yeah, I definitely would agree with that because, I mean, when I'm around anybody else, it seems like the only reason that I'm even there is to try and connect with them. And if I can't connect with them, what's the point of it?
And it makes you a little needy, I guess, in that way. I'm going to let you go. Definitely. Hard to understand you tonight. Thanks for the call at 855-450-FREE. You may take control here. You can also get on via Skype, as did Liberty Phoenix. Let's continue. We've got Phil in Michigan. Phil, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. I was calling to talk about the ongoing long-gone open carry thing going on at Chipotle you guys were talking about a few days ago.
Phil, I was hoping that some point you would call in to talk about this.
Now, Phil is actually an open carry activist in Michigan.
I'm the president of Michigan Open Carry Incorporated.
Yeah, and so for those that don't recall the story, there was an incident recently at a Chipotle restaurant in Texas where two men at least came into the restaurant with rifles. They had
slung across their fronts.
One man was holding the rifle at the ready, essentially pointed at the ground. The other man was sort of resting on the rifle in the photograph that was taken. They both had big smiles on their faces and seemed very proud of themselves. And ultimately, Chipotle issued a statement essentially sternly requesting that their customers no longer open carry and or carry weapons at all into their restaurants. And generally, I think, Mark, to summarize our position, because I think you agreed with me on this one, was that this was an entirely inappropriate place to do open carry activism, that private property is not ground to be taken, that things like this are much more appropriate in a public space. But interested to hear how you feel about it, Phil.
Well, you know, our first a few disclaimers, Michigan Open Carry Incorporated, we deal with handguns. We don't deal with long guns. We deal with a lawful open carry of a holstered handgun.
Well, of course, in Texas, you can't open carry a handgun.
Absolutely. And we also, whenever we work, we have these open carry gatherings around the state at restaurants. And our standard operating procedure is we call up the restaurant in advance, let them know, hey, we're going to be bringing about 30 people by. And by the way, they're going to be openly, most of them are going to be openly carrying handguns. Do you guys have a problem with that? Most of the times they welcome us with open arms. Sometimes they say, well, you know, we'd rather not have your business. And we say, okay, that's fine. And then we go to a nearby place. When we find a place nearby, we have our dinner there. And, you know, 30 people give us their cash receipts from their purchases that night. And we walk those cash receipts over to the business that turned us away. And we say, oh, by the way, here's a business you missed out on. So that's kind of our standard operating procedure.
I think it's a fine idea.
We work with the management of the place that we're going to before we just jump in on them. And that's just kind of how we run things. Now, I will say Chipotle.
Just a quick question, though, before you go on. When you go into the restaurant, are the members of your group brandishing the firearms at any point while they're inside?
We strictly encourage people. In fact, if someone were to take a gun out of a holster, we very politely pull them aside and say, no, you got to keep that in the holster.
Okay.
All guns always stay in the holster.
Sounds good.
A holstered handgun is a safe handgun because the trigger is protected by the holster.
Yep.
With regards to Chipotle, I think that they issued their statements mostly in regards to Mon's demand action. They've been putting a lot of pressure on places like Starbucks and Chipotle. And if you look at their statement, it was a very lightly worded, almost political pandering regarding this. They asked customers not to carry their. They didn't say that we're banning guns.
That's right.
So tonight, and I went to the local Chipotle here in Lansing, Michigan. There's no sign on the door. I just went in with my Glock, 9mm on my hip, ordered food, sat down, ate, and left. No problems.
Yeah, I mean, I don't disapprove of any of that. I mean, that all makes sense. If you're going to have some sort of an event, that you should have it with the consent of the property owner and or manager. That makes sense. To not wave guns around in the business makes sense. To just simply have it as a part of your repertoire, you know, just like you would have a cell phone on your belt, perhaps would make sense as well. In fact, no. As I pointed out in our discussion previously, if you're just going to a restaurant, you happen to be open carrying, that's one thing. But to go into a restaurant for the purpose of brandishing a rifle for a photo opportunity to make a point is absolutely ridiculous.
The point here is that in Texas, there is no open carry for short guns, but there's open carry of long guns. Yeah. And I think that it makes perfectly fine sense to go out to a public space and say, hey, look, I'm out here. Completely legal, open carrying my long gun. Why is it that I can't open carry my handgun on my hip?
Totally agree. Hey, Phil, anything else you want to share?
Well, when I go to the grocery store, I normally open carry, but it's about out and about in my everyday life. You know, it's just use common sense.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-453.
Common sense, not so common.
Yeah, you can take control here. We're going to talk more about this isolation discussion here in moments with Brett from the School Sucks Project, and your calls welcome at 855-453. Bring up anything here on Free Talk Live.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference, one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com.
What if humans found a habitable planet, set up housekeeping, and then got left alone by Earth and its big government? Well, that happened in Freehold, Michael Z. Williamson's seminal work. Now available for the first time in a signed, limited hardback edition. Other books in the series are also available in paperback. I cannot recommend a modern fiction work more highly than Freehold. Earth might have left Freehold alone, but it doesn't stay that way. It's war. Get your copy right now at all major booksellers and shop.freetalklive.com.
Gold isn't for you?
Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should, too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Seniors thunder into a local high school parking lot like coalition forces entering Baghdad. A substitute teacher just needs to make it to her car before breaking down in tears. And a college freshman tells his roommate there's no need to hide his masturbation from him. And now a week in review that truly requires no introduction. The nation's students announced this week that they have reluctantly agreed to give the American education system yet another chance, saying they hope educators keep their promises of smaller class size, better school supplies, and intensified efforts to raise the country's international math ranking. The nation's students vowed to give the education system one more shot, despite claiming to have been burned many, many times in the past. In other news, a man overcomes alcoholism without the help of Jesus, and an outcast student and a lonely teacher have begun a somewhat endearing sexual relationship. And that was a free lesson in top-shelf journalism. For more news, videos, and reminders of your insignificance, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, bring up what you want, take control toll-free, 855-450-FREE, and join us online over at freetalklive.com. With all the features on the site we give away, so please enjoy them. Once again, freetalklive.com.
Bitcoins are all over the news. As a matter of fact, I've been watching them all day for several days, just sort of watching the price move. I like to go to bitcoinaverage.com. They're currently at $575 per Bitcoin. A few days ago, they were at $400. So
it's been like a week, though.
$450, that, yeah. Probably more accurate. Anyway, been quite a rise in Bitcoins, and you can go get some at cashintocoins.com. I think it's one of the best places to go get it as far as rate goes. The instructions there are easy, safe, fast, completely legal, inexpensive, and customer service is their top priority. You can use a money order or a check or a wire transfer. Great rates, and you can actually get no fee at all if you buy fewer than $40 worth. So cashintocoins.com, go try them out. They want you to you know, buy just a few, just a little few millibits and try it out. That way, you know, you get some Bitcoins in your hand, then you'll want more. Cash into coins.com.
All right, we're talking about isolation, or we have been off and on throughout the show, mostly on. It's been the overarching discussion that we've been having here, and Brett from the School Sucks Project is sharing with us a story. What was the source on that?
This is from BBC Future, that's right. And the title is called How Extreme Isolation Warps the Mind.
So at first they've been interviewing a young lady who was kidnapped by Iranian soldiers, alleged that she was a spy. They held her in isolation for something like 400 plus days.
Yes.
So let's continue the story.
Oh, and just a side note here, the author of this is John Bond, and he wrote a book called The Power of Others. This article is based on that book, the research from that book. So I'm just going to back up to the beginning of the last paragraph we read. We all want to be alone from time to time to escape the demands of our colleagues or the hassle of crowds. But not alone alone. For some people, prolonged social isolation is all bad, particularly mentally. We know this not only from reports by people like Shord, who have experienced it firsthand, but also from psychological experiments on the effects of isolation and sensory deprivation, some of which had to be called off due to extreme and bizarre reactions of those involved. Why does the mind unravel so spectacularly when we're truly on our own? And is there any way to stop it?
I think the answer is that we're social creatures. There's really nothing you can do to change the nature of humans. Humans are as humans are. Some are going to be more interested in isolation, self-imposed isolation, than others, but we all have to have that socialization.
Yes, yes, absolutely. We've known for a while that isolation is physically bad for us. Chronically lonely people have higher blood pressure, are more vulnerable to infection, and are also more likely to develop Alzheimer's disease and dementia. Loneliness also interferes with a whole range of everyday functioning, such as sleep patterns, attention and logical and verbal reasoning. And the mechanisms behind these effects are still unclear, though what is known is that the social isolation unleashes an extreme immune response, a cascade of stress hormones, and inflammation. This may have been appropriate in our early ancestors, when being isolated from the group carried big physical risks, but for us, the outcome is mostly harmful. Yet, some of the most profound effects of loneliness are on the mind. For starters, isolation messes with our sense of time. One of the strangest effects is the time shifting reported by those who have spent long periods living underground without daylight. In 1961, French geologist Michel Seffry led a two-week expedition to study an underground glacier beneath the French Alps and ended up staying 2 months.
Whoa.
Yep. Kind of by accident.
That's a little scary.
He was fascinated by how the darkness affected human biology.
I understand the circadian rhythm is 25 hours. So what happens is that we get onto a different clock. When there isn't a sun rising and setting, we get onto a different clock, and that, you know, throws everything off.
It's crazy clock.
Right.
They'll do this in, I know Bradley Manning, now known as Chelsea Manning, when she was a he and was being kept in a prison cell awaiting trial, they did have 24-hour lighting in there. And so the lights never went off. There was never any indicator of what time of day it was. That could be very, very disorienting.
Mm, yes. So the a French biologist we were talking about decided to abandon his watch and live like an animal. While conducting tests with his team on the surface, they discovered it took him 5 minutes to count what he thought was 120 seconds. So think about it. I mean, that's, you know, 2 minutes versus 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. That's a pretty significant distortion in your sense of time.
Yeah.
A similar,
but we're not very good at those kind of periods of time. I mean, it's a special kind of intellect that can get you within a few seconds of counting to 120 seconds.
Sure, but I mean, we have also like a pretty proven method for doing it in small amounts of time by going 1/1000 to 1,000. Like, you're going to be pretty close. You should be within 5, maybe 10 seconds if you count to 60 or 120 that way.
Okay. I I think you need to, because I can count 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 1,000 fast too. So there's this kind of, I don't know that that method is foolproof. It never has worked for me.
Well, I think you'd have to be mindful of it, right? You'd have to be trying. Like,
I think you have to practice. I mean, you have to get an opportunity to really sort of time it out ahead of time. And if he didn't have that opportunity, then I don't know how long a second is.
All right. Well, there's some more extreme examples coming up in the article here. A similar pattern of slowing time was reported by Maurizio Montalbani, a sociologist and caving enthusiast. In 1993, Montalbani, spent three...
Either way, it's one hell of a name.
It's a beautiful name. Spent 366 days in an underground cavern near Pesaro in Italy that had been designed with NASA to simulate space missions, breaking his own world record for time spent underground. When he emerged, he was convinced only 219 days had passed. His sleep-awake cycles had almost doubled in length, so pretty consistent with the time distortions we found before.
So he, doubled in length?
Yeah.
So he's staying awake for something like, if you're awake for 18 hours, he's awake for 36 hours, and then sleeping for something like... 16 hours?
12 hours, yeah, almost exactly. Since then, researchers have found that in the darkness, most people eventually adjust to a 48-hour cycle. 36 hours of activity.
This isn't what I read at all decades ago.
36 hours of activity followed by 12 hours of sleep. The reasons are still unclear. As well as their time shifts, Sifri and Montalbini reported periods of mental instability, too. But these experiences were nothing compared with the extreme reactions seen in notorious sensory deprivation experiments in the mid-20th century. In the 1950s and 1960s, China was rumored to be using solitary confinement to brainwash American prisoners captured during the Korean War. And the U.S. and Canadian governments were all too keen to try it out. They sure were.
Let's get into it here in moments. Questionable scientific studies. They're very interesting.
Yes.
They're not supposed to do them certain ways, but they've been done anyway. And the results are usually pretty interesting when they do. 855-450-FREE. We'll find out what they learned or observed here in moments. And you can share your experience with isolation. If you've got some, the toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
You've been lied to. Lied to by corrupt Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine. My name is Brett Kitchen, and I want to give you a free copy of my Inc. magazine best-selling book, Safe Money Millionaire, because Wall Street's 401k and other investment plans have failed millions of Americans. After losing 35% in my IRA in the crash several years ago, I said enough. Since then, I've discovered an IRS-approved way to safely grow my money up to 12 to even 17%, cut taxes dramatically, but also have my money protected when the next crash comes. Call now to talk with a specialist to discover this little-known strategy to potentially build $1 million tax-free retirement income, get potential 12 to 17% returns, and never lose when the next crash hits. Call 888-885-8820 and discover this tool that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney used to safely grow rich. Plus, get one of just 97 free books left. We even cover shipping and handling. Call 888-885-8820. 888-885-8820. Again, that's 888-885-8820.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is novelist Tom Robbins. When my mother was diagnosed with glaucoma, her conservative Virginia physician told her there was only one treatment that might ease her pain and save her eyesight. That treatment was medical marijuana, which he could not prescribe. I offered to get her some and teach her how to use it effectively, but my father objected because marijuana was against the law. So my mother, who loved to read and walk in nature, was condemned to grow cruelly, unnecessarily blind. Tragedies like this happen all the time, but they don't have to keep happening. To learn more about medical marijuana, call the Marijuana Policy Project at 1-877-JOIN-MPP or visit them on the web at mpp.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Take control, toll-free here. This is Free Talk Live. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Our username is lrn.fm. You will have to send a contact request first if you have not yet done so. So do that first. Then after that, it'll be easy for you to get in touch with us through Skype. And most of the time, Skype sounds pretty darn good. The toll-free number, again, though, is 855-450-FREE. If you don't do the Skype thing, that's always an option for you.
The first Bitcoin conference to come to the Midwest. It's the North American Bitcoin Conference, held at Chicago's Cormac Place South Building, July the 19th and 20th. There's going to be a whole array of speakers there talking about every aspect of Bitcoins and how they fit into the new world that's going to be brought upon us by, hopefully, this exciting new currency. Trace Meyer of the Armory Wallet's going to be there. Peter Smith of blockchain.info, Ian and I, of course, are going to be there. Charlie Lee, the creator of Litecoin, Roger Ver, known as Bitcoin Jesus. As a matter of fact, Ian, did you get to hear the story about how Roger Ver offered the reward for...
Some hacker, right?
The hacker that had taken over his memorydealers.com website?
I didn't know what the hacker was alleged to have done. I knew Roger Ver was offering a large Bitcoin reward for someone who would somehow help bring the hacker to some level of responsibility. But then I heard the hacker turned himself in or something like that.
Well, that's because the hacker knew that he was going to get nabbed, and he just wanted to throw himself on the mercy of Roger so that he didn't have somebody coming after him. You know, one of the things, I guess one of the things he claimed is he was afraid of having a hit put out on him. And
which Roger had not done.
No, Roger hadn't done anything like that. But, you know, I think that it's I think it's interesting that justice was meted out so much more quickly than it could have been done otherwise. And I thought it was fascinating. Anyway, get your Bitcoin, your tickets with Bitcoin at btcchicago.com. That's btcchicago.com. Come see us. Do a couple of episodes of Free Talk Live right there on site and have a great time. Mingle. There'll be all kinds of networking opportunities.
I'm sure love these Bitcoin conferences. I mean, we've been to a few of them now. And it's always a different crowd because, like you're saying, this is the first one in the Midwest. So it's going to attract people who couldn't go to Miami and who couldn't go to Texas, but they can go to Chicago. So very cool.
Yep. I think it's going to be great.
What's the website? btcchicago.com. All right, so we'll see you there. Now, Brett, we've been talking about isolation, and I'd like to continue on that from the BBC.
Yep.
Let's continue with the discussion.
Sure. And we're just starting to get into the studies in solitary confinement and sensory deprivation.
They said there were some questionable studies that were done in, what was it, the Well, the 40s?
Yeah, 50s and 60s. 50s, and okay. It started with this rumor that China was, isolating and brainwashing prisoners of war. So obviously, rival governments wanted to find out what those experiments were and not stop them, but mimic them for their own use. So
this is terrible torture. We must see how this affects people.
The Defense Departments, and it's talking here about U.S. and Canada, funded a series of research programs that might be considered ethically dubious today.
They were ethically dubious then, too.
That's
true. This was only the 1950s.
The most extensive took place at McGill University Medical Center in Montreal, led by the psychologist Donald Hibb. The McGill researchers invited paid volunteers, mainly college students, to spend days or weeks by themselves in soundproof cubicles, deprived of meaningful human contact. Their aim was to reduce perceptual stimulation to a minimum to see how their subjects would behave when almost nothing was happening. They minimized what they could feel, see, hear, and touch, fitting them with translucent visors, cotton gloves, and cardboard cuffs extending beyond the fingertips. As Scientific American magazine reported at the time, they had them lie on U-shaped foam pillows to restrict noise and set up a continuous hum of air conditioning units to mask small sounds.
Okay.
After only a few hours, the students became acutely restless. They started to crave stimulation, talking, singing, or reciting poetry to themselves to break the monotony. Later, many of them became anxious or highly emotional. Their mental performance suffered too, struggling with arithmetic and word association tests.
Couldn't even do math problems.
Right. But the most alarming effects were the hallucinations. They would start with points of light, lines or shapes, eventually evolving into bizarre scenes, such as squirrels marching with sacks over their shoulders or processions of eyeglasses filing down a street. They had no control over what they saw. One man saw only dogs, another, babies.
And I wonder after how long these hallucinations were setting in.
Yeah, it doesn't.
It's not made clear in the article.
It doesn't say, no. I mean, it talks about the anxiety and extreme restlessness.
Starting within hours,
but I would think that this probably took much longer in some cases.
The terminology here says that they invited college students to participate. And these sound really awesome, but I wonder whether the guy that's hallucinating dogs he still wants to be there. Or are they forcing him to stay there, no one's coming in and saying, would you like to cease participation now?
Well, there may be some sort of way out, some kind of safe word or something like that.
That sounds like really nice, really, for people.
Then again, these were government studies,
can't
so, yeah.
do math anymore, have a safe right. word or button that they might be able to find through all the dogs all over the place.
Right. So say uncle when you start seeing dogs,
yeah.
and we'll open the door. Well, I mean, they're probably government-funded studies, but they are going on in universities where I could imagine there might be more compassion here and there. So it's not like it's an underground government bunker where this is happening.
Okay.
And, it was actually just in a similar type of experiment that was causing, significant emotional distress for the participants. The Stanford prison experiment. It was actually Zimbardo's girlfriend who got him to, she saw what he was doing and she says, you got to stop.
Really?
Yeah,
okay.
And that's why it stopped. So, all right. Some experienced sound hallucinations as well. A music box or a choir, for instance. Others imagined sensations of touch. One man had the sense he had been hit in the arm by pellets fired from guns.
Ouch.
Another reaching out to touch a doorknob felt an electric shock. When they emerged from the experiment, they found it hard to shake this altered sense of reality, convinced that the whole room was in motion, or that objects were constantly changing shape and size.
So, wow.
All right, new heading, distressing end. The researchers had hoped to observe their subjects over several weeks, but the trial was cut short because they became too distressed to carry on. Few lasted beyond 2 days, and none lasted as long as a week. Afterwards, Hebb wrote in the journal American Psychologist that the results were, quote, very unsettling to us. It is one thing to hear that the Chinese are brainwashing their prisoners on the other side of the world. It is another to find in your own laboratory that merely taking away the usual sights, sounds, and bodily contacts from a healthy university student for a few days can shake him right down to the base.
I wonder about these people, that these spelunkers that you were talking about earlier, going down in these caverns for half a year to a year in two different instances. Well, are these people special, or is it that they were getting enough stimulation from their environment?
That's it. Yeah, that's got to be it, because this is robbing people of stimulation.
All stimulation.
Right. Yeah. So, and I think it also, if you're in a situation like that, you're probably going to feel like you're pretty safe, you know, like if you have cuffs and you're on soft pillows and there's air conditioners running in a white room, you probably feel a little less threatened than if you're, you know, out in the wilderness or going into some deep, dark cave. So the survival instinct might not kick in as much.
And it also makes me wonder about people on death row, people in isolation cells. I mean, these things are relatively common in America's prisons. Why do these people not go bananas? And they do. I mean, I've been in confinement cells in prison right after they sprayed pepper spray in on some inmate that went bananas in there.
So you're saying some people don't go bananas?
Well, I think some people can handle more and less stimulation.
I imagine that's true. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You're welcome to share your thoughts, experiences, and or bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. Still on the way, the hopes of North Korea's black market generation. We'll find out about what that's all about on Free Talk Live.
What if you could combine the two most powerful diet ingredients into one incredible weight loss super pill? We've done just that. For the first time ever, the miracle fat burner in a bottle, raspberry ketone, has been combined with pure Garcinia Cambogia, described as the holy grail of weight loss, to bring you the world's most powerful diet pill. Get your phone ready, because we're releasing free bottles to the first 100 callers. But wait, we haven't just combined the two most powerful weight loss ingredients. We've combined the six most powerful ingredients. Green coffee bean, African mango, moringa, and glucomannan. All the hottest clinically proven weight loss ingredients combined into one fat-shedding super pill. We call it the Skinny 6 Super Supplement, and it's available for the very first time. Be one of the first 100 callers, and we'll rush you a free bottle. Call 1-800-514-2945. Find out how to get your free bottle. 1-800-514-2945. 1-800-514-2945.
Gentlemen, in search of a million-dollar smile that'll make them take notice, I mean really get their attention, then get the mud. My Magic Mud. The fluoride-free whitener with no chemicals, additives, GMOs, or bad taste. And safe to swallow. My Magic Mud detoxifies, reduces sensitivity, cleans and strengthens your teeth while it whitens. Comes as a powder for pure whitening power. Start looking good for that special someone. Get the mud now. MyMagicMud.com.
It's already too late. Criminals have kicked in your door and are now in your home. Before this happens, homeowners have a choice. One, do nothing and hope you aren't one of the 1.4 million families attacked each year. Or two, refuse to be a victim. And for as low as $59, reinforce your doors with Door Devils. Door Devils simply attach to existing door frames and have proven to stop the biggest bad guys from kicking in doors. Read our police testimonials of real-life events at DoorDevil.com. Alarms don't stop kick-ins. We do. DoorDevil.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you are invited here toll-free at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. And join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that we share with you. And if you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, lots of different ways to do that. One of them is to become a Free Talk Live amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. I'll tell you how to get a cup, not just a cup, a pound of coffee. Some of the best coffee available for free.
You go to coffee.freetalklive.com. It's that easy. Sign up for the subscription there. You'll get your first pound of BuzzBox coffee that's completely shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica beans. You'll get it completely free. Now, you pay for the shipping, and you can cancel the subscription at any time. But BuzzBox does some things that your coffee company probably doesn't do. Well, for one, they're organic, and when it comes to coffee, which is a very absorbent product, you know, and it's mostly grown in third world countries where perhaps they don't have rules on things like, oh, I don't know, DDT and leaded gas. The organic certification takes on a whole new light in that circumstance. Well, they also try very hard to take good care of their farmers. You know, they grow in a sustainable fashion, and they have a co-op that people can get involved in. They also allow partners like Free Talk Live to give microloans to use some of our profits to give microloans to people that around the world that need a hand up instead of a handout. So go get your coffee at coffee.freetalklive.com. Get the free pound and continue getting the subscription. For every 10 people that do that, we're able to give another microloan to another family. Just put a story up on the Facebook page at facebook.freetalklive.com talking about a family in Africa that has used a microloan to get a sewing machine is now making shoes for their villages, nice. Their village and surrounding area. So there you go, coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, let's go to the phones here and actually to Skype, where Nathan is on the line in Texas. Go ahead, Nathan.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
I remember when I first started reading libertarian-type literature like Harry Brown and that kind of stuff, I remember reading a lot about this idea of, you know, governments kind of torturing people with isolation and things like that, and like in 1984, like in that book. So I guess I've always considered isolation to be a form of torture. I don't know how new a notion this is.
Not very.
Okay. Well, I wanted to kind of shift the topic a little bit to something Liberty Phoenix brought up, and that was not kind of literal isolation, but more, I guess, kind of political isolation. Forgive me if you guys talked about this in the first hour, but I was curious because I know in that Free State Project ad, Ian, you frequently mentioned, you know, are you feeling alone? You perhaps feel that you're not connected to the people around you. Maybe you should move to the Free State Project. I was wondering, it seems like people feel isolated, or they can feel isolated even with other people. And I was wondering, what do you guys think about that and how it relates to, I guess, politics?
All right. Well, actual isolation of not being around other people is activating, you know, like a biosurvival cue, right? So it's more physiological what's happening, but the kind of isolation that you're talking about is
mental,
is more emotional. Yeah, because you're around other people, and especially a lot of us have experience like trying to talk to family or friends about some of these political issues, and right, you know, surrounded by people who we know or love, yeah, we can feel very isolated.
You can't connect.
Yeah, philosophically, like we can't make connections. But I think that's a little bit different, right? And that's also certainly unhealthy, where the article that we're talking about tonight is talking more physiologically. What is the impact of that? But I mean, that relates to the question I asked Mark. Like, you know, when you're in a place where there's a bunch of people and you're not having positive social interactions, what are the negative impacts of that?
Yeah, it seems like people want, to some extent, they want their values to be validated by others. I mean, that's how I think of it sometimes, which seems kind of weird, right? Like, if you believe something, then it seems like you should believe that. Whether it's politics or whatever else, but you find people who are, you know, like atheists in church, or I don't know, Republicans who live in LA. I don't know, you know, just examples of people who like.
You find examples of atheists in church?
Well, people who are, you know, kind of turning that direction and feeling less connected to the people around them. It just seems like people want to be around others who share their values. And I was wondering what
you
guys think.
Why would the atheists go to church? I'm missing that point.
Are you saying like they're on their way out? They're on their way out of church.
Right.
Oh, okay.
I think that there are atheists, absolutely people that have gone for years to church that don't really believe in a God very thoroughly. Mm-hmm. They just go for whatever reason. I think most people in church aren't that philosophically attached to the ideas that are preached from the pulpit.
They just go there around other people.
It's a social organization. Church has always been a social organization.
They have donuts.
Well, they've got coffee. They've got people to talk to. They've got people to marry. There are reasons to get out of an agrarian. And when you're in an agrarian culture, you're much less likely to talk to your neighbors because you're busy trying to eke a living out of the dirt. Most of society was agrarian in this country prior to 1920, and still is around the world. They need social organizations to get them out of the house. The knitting club isn't going to be good enough because it doesn't have that pull of eternal damnation that church has.
Well, it shouldn't be a surprise, Nathan, that people are seeking others who agree with them. I mean, it would be pretty uncomfortable to be constantly around people who are challenging your belief system, right? So it's much more of a comfortable circumstance to be around others who generally agree with you.
I think some of us might, though, look forward to opportunities to mix it up a little bit with
people. That's one thing to look for an opportunity like that, but I think people are naturally attracted to people who share a common belief system. Otherwise, it could be pretty uncomfortable if every time you were to go and spend time with people, you were getting into some sort of a debate or conflict. That would kind of be wearing.
Well, it is wearing. If you're a radio talk show host, I mean, what do you? I don't know what it's like for you, Ian, but what my conversations with people are like. What do you do for a living? Well, I host a radio talk show. Oh yeah, left or right? Well, actually, we don't really do left or right talk. We're neither Republican nor Democrat, and as a matter of fact, the show's syndicated on both liberal and conservative stations. Well, so what do you guys talk about? Well, we talk about the issues of the day, and we usually take them from a pro-liberty standpoint. Well, pro-liberty, huh? You're a libertarian. Yes, yeah, I guess you can use that terminology. As long as you don't paint me with the same brush you use other libertarians on. Well, yeah, well, what do you think about such and such? Well, I guess if I had to come down with a statement, I would, say this and this, this. Yeah, well, what about this?
I'm sorry. I meant to say I work at Radio Shack. Right. I meant to say I work at Radio Shack. Yeah.
I mean, this is a real joy. Oh, you've always wanted to be a radio talk show caller, but you've never bothered to pick up the phone.
Right.
So now you're going to use me here at this cocktail party as your personal foil.
Look, here's our call-in line number.
No, thanks.
I'll be on the air tonight at 7. Thanks, Nathan, for the call tonight. 855-450-FREE. You bring up anything. Shannon's in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Shannon.
Yes, hello. I have a situation that happened to me here a while back, and I would like for you and your listeners to be aware of this. And I'm giving you an exclusive interview, as I have had multiple news medias try to interview me, and I refuse because they want to edit everything. And the only way I would do an interview was if it was unedited.
Okay.
I've been on TV. I've been on television quite a bit. I've been on a lot of radio stations. I have traveled the globe and been on television. I actually got famous in 2007 for finding an amputated human foot in a grill.
In a where?
I found an amputated human foot in a smoker, like you make barbecue in on a weekend.
In a grill. Okay. I thought that's what you said. Just wanted to make sure. Where was the grill?
It was actually in a little town called Maiden, North Carolina. However, since then,
how do you spell that? Maiden?
Yes, M-A-I-D-E-N.
Okay. Tell me more.
You can go to Google and type in man finds foot in smoker. Watch the first video. It's a real knee slapper, they tell me, and it's me. Anyway, after that incident, there was always at least 8 people at my house, you know, friends wanting to rub elbows or what have you after that incident. And it kind of got old, and you can't really tell your friends, you know, look, you got to go home. I'm tired of this. I need some alone time with my wife, you know. And I couldn't be rude to my friends. So after we went on vacation one weekend, I told my wife, I said, let's move. You know, the second day we were home, I told her, I said, let's move. She said, why? Where are we going? I said, well, I can't go to Walmart. I can't go to the drugstore. I couldn't go anywhere without people just piling up on me, you know, and wanting to talk to me about it and everything. So we moved.
So this is kind of the opposite of isolation, actually. This is constant attacking of people wanting to talk to you and get a photo off with you. Hey, man, get the foot out. Let's take a picture. Hang on, Shannon. We'll bring it back here. You can tell more of your story here in a moment. A man found a foot in a grill, and it changed his life, apparently, for the worse. It's Free Talk Live.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
This is the Central Scrutinizer. I steal your labor by force through taxation.
My job is to spy on you and keep you from hearing things like the Freedom Fiends. I especially
do not want you to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to keep them drone-proof. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives.
Are you looking for camping, hunting, survival, or shooting gear? ManVentureOutpost.com carries the name brands you want at the lowest prices. Ammunition, knives, firearm accessories, archery, air guns, scopes, binoculars, laser sights, tactical flashlights, fish finders, and boating equipment. ManVentureOutpost.com is family-owned and has the lowest prices. Go check it for yourself. Get it quick. Get it from ManVentureOutpost.com.
Now buy firearms at ManVentureOutpost.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Radio VR.
Good morning and welcome to Radio VR. We're broadcasting live from Washington, D.C. and around the world on voiceofrussia.com/US. I'm Kate Zickel.
And I'm Rick Young. Today is Wednesday, May 28th, 2014.
Radio VR News.
A day after unveiling plans to keep troops in Afghanistan for another 2 years, President Obama is heading to West Point today to defend his foreign policy agenda against critics who call it weak. White House correspondent Mark Smith reports.
The critics point to Syria, Iran, and elsewhere and say Obama's confounding allies while emboldening foes. He says he successfully wound down 2 wars and avoided big errors.
You hit singles, you hit doubles every once in a while. We may be able to
hit a home run.
That's how he put it in Asia this month. But the RAND Corporation's Seth Jones says what he has yet to deliver is a clear rationale for when America should intervene and when it shouldn't.
What's the U.S.'s vision of engagement in the world?
That's what his speech to graduating cadets here aims to deliver. Mark Smith, West Point, New York.
The U.S. is getting closer to a decision on training and equipping moderate Syrian rebels. National security correspondent Sagar Magani reports from the Pentagon.
For 3 years, the moderate opposition trying to oust President Bashar Assad has been asking the U.S. for military help, but Washington's been reluctant, fearing extremist rebels could end up with the weapons and potentially use them against Israel or U.S. interests. But officials say the Pentagon, State Department, and others have concluded Assad will not budge unless the military situation changes. If President Obama signs off, the program would send a limited number of U.S. troops to Jordan as part of a regional mission to train parts of the Free Syrian Army. Sagar Meghani at the Pentagon.
The U.S. Supreme Court has sided with police in a case involving a car chase that was captured on video. Jerry Bolander has the details.
For the second time in 2 years, the justices viewed video from the dashboard camera of a police vehicle and sided with police who were charged with using excessive force. The court unanimously dismissed a civil rights claim against six officers from West Memphis, Arkansas, who were involved in the shooting of a driver and his passenger who were fleeing after a traffic stop. Writing for the court, Justice Samuel Alito said, "It is beyond serious dispute that the driver's flight posed a grave public safety risk, and police acted reasonably in using deadly force to end that risk." Jerry Bodlander, Washington.
The Federal Trade Commission is urging Congress to tighten up on data brokers and help consumers control the vast amounts of personal information being collected. David Melendi explains why.
FTC Chairwoman Edith Ramirez says the amount of information being collected on consumers is a real eye-opener.
The sheer magnitude of what's taking place, I think, is quite astonishing.
She says the FTC wants Congress to require more transparency by data brokers.
Open up and shed light on what they're doing.
And give consumers more control over how their personal information is used.
Data brokers are using our offline purchases and information as a way to locate us and target us online.
She says most consumers probably aren't even aware so much information about them is being brokered. David Melendi, Washington.
First Lady Michelle Obama says Congress should not be rolling back some school nutrition guidelines. Correspondent Tim McGuire has the details on the war over school lunches.
At a meeting with some school nutrition officials, Michelle Obama says she will not agree to easing school nutrition guidelines.
This is unacceptable.
The House Appropriations Committee is expected to approve an agriculture bill that would allow flexibility for school districts when it comes to rules requiring more fruits, vegetables, and whole grains and less sodium, sugar, and fat. Mrs. Obama says such changes would hurt the students.
The last thing that we can afford to do right now is play politics with our kids' health.
The districts say limits on sodium and whole grain requirements are particularly challenging. Tim McGuire, Washington.
And Los Angeles Clippers owner Donald Sterling is speaking out against rumors the California basketball team may be up for sale. Correspondent Brian Mahoney reports Sterling's comments contradict his wife Shelley's statements about the team's ownership.
His estranged wife Shelley is saying that he's given her permission to sell the team. And on the other hand, he's telling the league that he's not really going anywhere here, that he has rights to keep his team here, and he doesn't want to sell it because of the capital gain taxes he would pay, the fact that these charges don't seem they're legal in his mind, that wouldn't hold up in court.
And that's the news for Radio VR in Washington. I'm Kate Ziegel.
And I'm Rick Young.
House of Representatives Bill 323, the IHOP should stay open all night so we can get some pancakes act. This bill was submitted for immediate review very late last night under the provisions of the National Emergency Legislation Act.
Can we turn dim the lights? It's really
bright. H.R. 323 would, by federal order, require all IHOP restaurants to, quote, remain open 24 hours effective right this minute, even if some manager has to get out of bed and drive down here to start making some pancakes.
Well, we stand by the bill.
Right. We wrote it, apparently.
This bill would also require the federal government pay to build a tram or monorail or whatever connecting the Black Sheep Pub on North Capitol Street to all IHOP restaurants in
the city. I think we made some illustrations of
that. The bill gives the estimated cost of the tram as probably not even that much. You are wasting my time and the time of this committee.
Excuse me, I gotta go.
What? Congressman, this committee is still in session. You can't...
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour here. Plenty of time for your call and thoughts about whatever is on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And doing an open phones radio show, you never know who is going to call in. He's still on hold. If you're tuned in the last hour, Shannon called in from North Carolina, and he said his life has been turned upside down ever since an incident that happened. It appears to have happened several years ago there in North Carolina, where he found a foot inside a grill that he had purchased, a human foot. And he suggested that we do a little digging, try to research his case. I have done that. I did find the video to which he was referencing. The video is on MH10809 channel on YouTube. If you search for "man finds human foot inside a grill," it will come up. But I'm going to just go ahead and play it. It's a fairly short video, and then we're going to bring Shannon on, who is the subject of this this piece, to further comment on what happened and how his life apparently has changed. He says that he's being hounded by news media for comment on this. And, well, let me get into the story here from one of the local television stations.
See, this smoker, it is making national headlines, and the story starts right here in our own backyard.
Kind of unbelievable. A maiden man was hoping the grill would be the centerpiece of his backyard. But as Kristen Hampton shows us, a surprise inside may have ruined his appetite for a while.
There's never a dull moment around.
When it comes to Shannon Wisnant, you might could say that again.
Something weird happens to me all the time.
This story, weird indeed. It all started with this innocent old smoker grill. Wisnant bought it at an auction after the owner of one of these storage units didn't pay up on his bill. Wisnant took his treasure home. Pretty quick thereafter, he called 911.
And what's the problem there?
I got a human foot.
Have a what?
A human left foot.
What's your name?
My name's Shannon Winston. It's some nasty, got me grossed out. Roll it, couldn't help.
Tom. I love his first. The man realizes the guy just said he has a human foot, human left foot. The first question is, yeah, I'm going to have your name. It's the first thing he wants to know.
And you look at the lower third here on this this video, lower third being the little bar that they put across the bottom of the screen to give you some information. It's got his name, Shannon Wisnett, and then he's titled as Foot Finder.
Yep. We took a foot count here at home, and we have at least one more than we
than
should,
you should
have.
Yeah.
Help toe couldn't help. My stomach was in bad shape yesterday after I found this. Mm-hmm.
Wrapped up in some screen wire inside the smoker, a foot with a good section of lower leg attached.
I said, oh, my God, there's a human foot. My mother and her boyfriend said, I said, look for yourself. Five toes, five toenails.
A human foot.
Hard not to crack a smile now that cops know nothing criminal happened. Indeed, it was just a man who'd had his leg amputated years ago and wanted to keep it in this grill, in this shed. Wisnett now has sole ownership of the foot smoker, as he calls it, and even thought of keeping the bonus inside.
I thought that person.
And maybe Shannon will be able to answer this when we bring him back on the line here, but was it a cooked foot? Did the man whose foot it was
at all, no.
Go ahead and cook it? Well, if not, I mean, it'd be pretty nasty after it sat in a... either way, whether it was cooked or not, it'd be pretty nasty after it sat in a storage shed inside this grill and in no way being preserved at all.
I look forward to what Shannon has to say.
Well, there's a little bit more to this video here.
Pursuing the foot... Just as a conversation piece, religious or not, put it in an airtight box with a glass window on it.
For now, no peep shows for the foot. The cops are trying to get it back to its owner, and Wisnett's trying to turn his foot smoker into a tourist attraction.
You can come see it. Bob Cook Road off Business 321, $1 admission.
In Maiden, Kristen Hampton, WBTV News 3.
It is not a crime in North Carolina to have your own body part just so long as it's for religious reasons. Now, we asked that man, Lizard.
All right, Shannon, you're back on with us here in North Carolina. Now, you had said that you were thinking about leaving the area because you're constantly being approached by people. Is that right? And this is an old story. I mean, the YouTube video was posted in 2007. When did this originally happen?
It happened in 2007, September 2007. And okay. I moved about 5.5 years ago, something to that effect. We moved. My mother had a vacation home in Stacy, North Carolina, on the coast, and my mother was 70 years old. She was living in a home by herself, and I asked mother if she'd like to go with us where we could go fishing, go to the beach, you know, hang out, have a good time, and she was like, sure, I'd love to get out of this lonely house, you know. So mm-hmm. we packed our stuff, packed mother's stuff, and we left, and we come to the beach, and down here, I still don't go out in public very much because people still recognize me from being on TV so much.
Really?
And, yes, my name is a household name in Hollywood, California, and I've been told that many, many times. I have also created many television shows that were stolen from me by a Hollywood producer, which I will not announce, as I do have an attorney.
How did that happen, though? Can you talk about – all right, well, first of all – are you going to drop some kind of a bombshell on us here? Like this, the story we just watched was actually part of something much bigger. Like there was some kind of satanic cult or some kind of ritualistic sacrifice that the people in high levels of the media and police were in on, and they covered it up, and you were run out of town. I mean, that's what I thought, but. Nothing like that? Okay.
Hold on. I'm missing a couple of links here, Shannon, yeah. And maybe you could fill in the gaps for me. So 2007, September, you find a foot. The call is made. The media finds out somehow about this. Maybe they were listening to the police dispatch or something like that. They found out. They picked up the story. Then you started getting more media attention beyond this about the foot. How did that translate into Hollywood producers stealing your ideas for television programs?
Well, let me first state this. When all this started and took place, I had a cell phone and my wife had a cell phone. They were 2 digits apart. Neither one of those stopped ringing for 5 minutes. Until about midnight. And I did radio shows all over the United States and Canada. I did interviews for magazines and newspapers all over the world, Australia, Germany, just all over, more places than I can name off without having all sure. the info in front of me. But the reason of my calling in tonight, I've been asked to run for president of the United States twice. My IQ is 163,
wow.
Which I've been told my IQ is extremely high.
That is very high.
And I have a huge, wonderful plan to make this country great again, and make it shoulders above the rest.
Now, I want to know, how are you going to go up against a man like Vermin Supreme? I mean, in the presidential contest, there are some pretty serious contenders out there, and Vermin Supreme is one of them. He's been at it year after year. I mean, every 4 years, Vermin has thrown in his hat and has become more and more of a contender over time. And I'm just wondering, how are you going to respond to him?
Well, I've not had a chance to debate with him, which I would invite him any day, anywhere, anytime,
oh, wow.
any place.
I have to say, this would be an epic debate, having you, Shannon, versus Vermin Supreme. Now, where can people go? Is there a campaign website, or are you planning on running for president, or are you just being encouraged to run for president?
I'm trying my best to run for president of the United States, make this country great again for our future and our next generation, our children, your children's children, so forth and so on.
Are you going to try to tie the foot incident into the campaign slogans, like elect Shannon,
no.
He'll put a real foot up the country's butt, or something like that, something to kind of go with the celebrity that you've earned here to try to promote yourself?
I may do that. However, if anyone's interested and would like to see my personal views and look at my page, I have a group page.
Hang on. I want you to tell me more, but I want to have to bring you back. More with Shannon coming up.
What if you could combine the two most powerful diet ingredients into one incredible weight loss super pill? We've done just that. For the first time ever, the miracle fat burner in a bottle, raspberry ketone, has been combined with pure Garcinia Cambogia, described as the holy grail of weight loss, to bring you the world's most powerful diet pill. Get your phone ready, because we're releasing free bottles to the first 100 callers. But wait, we haven't just combined the two most powerful weight loss ingredients. We've combined the six most powerful ingredients. Green coffee bean, African mango, moringa, and glucomannan. All the hottest clinically proven weight loss ingredients combined into one fat-shedding super pill. We call it the Skinny 6 Super Supplement, and it's available for the very first time. Be one of the first 100 callers, and we'll rush you a free bottle. Call 1-800-514-2945. Find out how to get your free bottle. 1-800-514-2945. 1-800-514-2945.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com. MindThings.com is a fun online game that pits you against people around the world to mine for scarce resources. Do business in a capitalist economy with virtually mined gold, tax-free. It doesn't require a big-time commitment. Your little mining robot guy works whether you're logged in or not. It costs nothing to play, but you can buy bonuses. They even accept bitcoins. Go to MindThings.com, use coupon code FTL, and double your mining speed. It's free. MindThings.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, bring up whatever you want here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features on our site. They're all free. Those other talk show hosts, they want to charge you. Most of the big-name talk show hosts want to charge you for their websites. Ours is free, so enjoy it. freetalklive.com.
My Magic Mud. This is a tooth powder that I've been using for about the last week. And Ian, you got a jar of it too. I found it to be great. It removed, within the first four applications, it removed some very tough coffee stains from my teeth. Just got rid of them. And my mouth has a sort of a clean, polished feeling that it doesn't generally have after brushing my teeth. What it does is it removes plaque and detoxifies the mouth of bacteria that, of course, cause cavities and gingivitis and things like that. It gives you this dentist clean feeling every time you use it. It's gentle on the enamel. The ingredients of My Magic Mud are also used as dietary supplements, so it's not only an effective whitener, but it's safe to swallow. My Magic Mud is a teeth whitening powder that strengthens your teeth and promotes healthy gums. It reverses sensitivity and soothes any pain you may be dealing with. It was created by Jessica Armand, who I interviewed on the Edgington Post. She's a liberty-loving homeschool mother of three, and she'll be attending Porkfest this year, and My Magic Mud will be available there for purchase. You can actually try it out. If you are listening and you want to get My Magic Mud because I highly recommend this product. Your mouth hasn't felt like this before. MyMagicMud.com. On the website, you can listen to an interview with the biological dentist, Dr. Griffin Cole. So he explains a lot of the benefits of My Magic Mud. It's made out of activated charcoal and bentonite clay. And it's really amazing stuff. MyMagicMud.com.
Shannon is with us still in North Carolina. Now, Shannon, you made headlines back in 2007 after finding a foot in a grill that you purchased from what appeared to be some sort of an auction of a storage unit. So just some junk from a storage unit was being sold. You got a grill out of the deal, and you didn't realize you were also getting a foot out of the deal as well. It was apparently inside the grill. Some portion of a leg was attached to said foot. The police were alerted. The media found out, and you ended up having to move out of the area with the hopes that the pressure from all the people in the area who wanted to talk to you when they saw you, you know, if you're out shopping or walking downtown, they were recognizing you, and it was getting to you. The level of celebrity that you'd had over this was frustrating. You tried moving. That apparently didn't solve the problem because you moved within North Carolina, and apparently there were still some people in the area to which you moved that were aware of you. You say that you are sort of like a celebrity there.
In Hollywood, California, you said.
And you also claim that you are a celebrity in Hollywood, a household name, I believe you said, and that apparently you had some ideas for some television shows that some producers stole. And on top of all that, you plan on running for president is it the 2016 election that you're going to be running for president, or will be later on?
That's a big 10-4, 2016, buddy. 2016.
Now, you were about to give us your website or a group on Facebook somewhere where people could go to connect with you?
Yes, go to Facebook, and when you go to Facebook, you can look me up, Shannon Wisner, or you can type in the Pissed Off People's Party 2016. That's my platform I created. Because the Republicans didn't like what I had to say, the Republicans didn't like what I had to say, the Democrats didn't like what I had to say, and the Libertarians didn't like what I had to say because of my stand on the death penalty. I think I could save all the states millions of dollars, all the inmates on death row. Why feed them and supply them with medication and doctor on them if you're going to kill them? String them up right quick and get it over with. Stop the waiting. Save money.
Make them fight lions. Sell tickets.
A way to generate some money.
Now, I've been asking a lot of the questions here, guys, and you've sort of been absorbing this. This is a big story. I mean, there's a lot going on here with Shannon. I'm wondering if you have any questions for him. I mean, we've got a presidential candidate on the lines with us here right now.
Backing away from the presidential candidate part of this, I would like to hear more, and I don't know how much you can say about it, but what happened with Hollywood? You said you're a household name in Hollywood. you had ideas for television shows. I know that that is a dirty business filled with, you know, lots of really scummy people for sure. Can you tell us a little bit about what happened or what the television shows were, why they were stolen, anything like that?
I can tell you I pitched 15 television shows, and out of those, 12 of those are on air right now, and they're doing extremely well.
Can you tell us any of them? Can you tell us the names of any of them?
I'll tell you a name of two, and one was pulled, and the other one they're having an issue with because of me. One was pulled, and the name of it was Airplane Repo. The other one was Dukes of Haggle, which they changed the name of it, and everything that I designed, created, and afforded to this producer was not directed properly. So, in other words, if it was directed properly, they would all be huge hits. Mm. And I said my name was a household name in Hollywood, California, because I've been told that many, many, many times over and over and over again. They are making a documentary about what happened to me,
and you called tonight because you wanted to give Free Talk Live an exclusive interview because you are turning down the news channels that are coming and still trying to talk to him. I mean, what's amazing to me is that you would have this much attention here 7 years later. Almost 7 whole years later on. Why do you think this story has such legs?
Well, it won't die. The story will never go away. But the reason I called tonight was I wanted to fill you in on an incident that happened to me after my life was threatened by Mr. Robert Gilbert, which had a Facebook page. And he said that he did contract work for corporations. And apparently he didn't like what I had to say in my presidential campaign. And he admitted to working for someone that is running for president in 2016. He did not name said party. And I called the FBI. They blew it off like a leaf in the wind and tried to report it to them. So I called the sheriff's department, and they sent out a deputy, and he filed a report. And I've called about every couple of weeks. I'll call this deputy, and he keeps giving me,
runaround. He's protecting the incumbency. He's protecting the political establishment. You know, Shannon, I have to say this is fascinating, and I would love to have you continue to check in on the road as the political campaign season heats up with us here on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I'd
love to do that. I'd love to do that, and I would also invite y'all to keep my personal cell number and call me anytime you like. But I have some things in my hands that I would like to discuss with you.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're going to have to do it at another time because we got to make room for other folks who want to get on the air here, Shannon. But thank you for the call tonight. I certainly appreciate hearing from you. Good luck in 2016. It's shaping up to be an interesting presidential campaign.
If he didn't like being mobbed over the foot he found in the grill, he's sure not going to like the mobbing he gets once he's president.
Well, it sounds like he's sort of on one hand frustrated, but on the other hand, must be embracing the publicity. And
I am interested in hearing from the First Lady.
All right, more coming up here. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live.
Do you owe the IRS money that you can't pay? Are tax liens and levies ruining your life? Are you tired of being afraid just to go to the mailbox? If this describes you, then Dan Pilla can help.
Hi, I'm Dan Pilla, and I've been solving tax problems for more than 30 years. In fact, I wrote the book that made it possible to negotiate settlements with the IRS, and I've helped thousands of people do exactly that. Call now at 800-346-6829 to learn how I can help you. You know your IRS debt will not go away by itself, but you don't have to live in fear anymore. New changes to IRS policies will help more people than ever before eliminate their debts once and for all. There's no need for you to suffer another day with IRS debt. Call 800-346-6829. I can help you eliminate wage and bank levies, release tax liens, and negotiate a settlement with the IRS that will put your tax nightmare behind you forever. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to my website, taxhelponline.com. That's taxhelponline.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict. or face increasing punishments, up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges start a conversation with your neighbor or your doctor or your family or your school. Now there's teachers and lawyers and business executives, and they all wear shiny badges and they all reject the state. Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges show the world that you reject coercion and aggression and oppression by the state. Shinybadges.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Email is easy, instant, and free, and that can be real embarrassing. Email lacks the eye contact and body language you get in face-to-face conversation, or the tone of voice and other nuance you hear in a telephone conversation. Email is just words, often few words. We're all smothering in spam, so we often reply in terse fashion that's easy to misunderstand. And email doesn't cost you a postage stamp, and it lacks the deliberation time it'd take to walk to the snail mailbox, so it's easy to succumb to the "oh yeah" stimulus response trap. When in doubt, don't snap back at snippy messages you get. You may have mistaken the sender's intent, and unless you're sending AOL to AOL, there's no unsend. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls about anything that you want to discuss here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, whether it's isolation or finding a foot in a grill and then running for president with your newfound publicity. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio tonight here, it's Ian.
Brett.
And Mark.
Brett is here courtesy of the School Sucks Project, and the School Sucks Project is a great website. It's got more than, you know, just a radio show on it. You also do a video version of your radio show, Brett. And there's a forum, as I understand it, that's fairly busy there with your listeners involved. And what else will be found at School Sucks Project?
Well, we've moved the forum, as many people have, to Facebook at this point.
Really? You shut your forum down?
It's still there, but it's like people just prefer to use the Facebook group.
I hate Facebook. It's just destroying everything about the internet.
It's definitely destroying, website forums.
Yeah.
So people can go and join our group. It's called the School Sucks Project on Facebook. And it is, even though I'd like to have a very robust forum, there was the recent show that I posted, which was what Ty called in, this call-in show with the historian Thaddeus Russell. People were in there all day going back and forth, and I think that's great. Facebook is always open, so it's easy. You know, you can just you don't have to go and find a thread. Things pop up in your little notifications. You say, I'm following that. You go to that thread, and you just type. So it does have its advantages as far as connecting with other people on certain topics or issues.
It does.
Fighting with them if you'd like, or, you know, having a constructive conversation.
What is the thrust of the School Sucks Project?
What does it do?
Well, the first thing we did was we wanted to point out why school was so destructive. And I think we accomplished that. We return and hit on that once in a while. And we really want to make the distinction between school and education. When we talk about being against government school, people often say, but how will the children be educated? They're not being educated in government school, not in any meaningful, long-lasting, intrinsically motivated way. So we talk a lot about what education really is, and we try to give examples. We teach intellectual self-defense, like how to spot the BS of politicians or maybe even some religious or advertising things through logical fallacies. And we try to talk about self-education and also things like productivity, organization, things that we think can really help people.
And you can listen for free, and it's done produced at least weekly.
Yes.
Sometimes
more
than that.
Yeah, yeah.
At schoolsucksproject.org.
.com.
Thank you. Schoolsucksproject.com. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Chris in Toronto. You're on Free Talk Live. Chris.
Hey, guys. Good evening.
Welcome. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I just sort of wanted to relay a personal story. I've been thinking about calling in for a few days now, and I just sort of thought that it was maybe like a touch of synchronicity with you guys talking about isolation and whatnot. So my story is not exactly related in the type of isolation you guys are talking about. But anyway, it's a positive story, so I just hope to share it, and hopefully maybe it reaches out to somebody out there. My story is more about kind of maybe like emotional isolation, although that's not the important part. But I just for anybody out there that, feels like that they are sort of cut off from everybody else, that they're really, really depressed, I just got a good story for them. Anyway, maybe not a good story, but anyway, about 15 years ago, I had a whole lot of traumatic events in my life, and it sort of set me down this path where I sort of cut myself off from everybody and sort of isolated myself, not just like physically, kind of becoming reclusive, but also emotionally too, cutting myself off from family and friends and anything I had, burning every bridge. obviously that does have significant consequences, as you guys talked about, things like, even weird stuff like that, how you lose your kind of concept of time. And, myself, I would just kind of like wallow alone in my room and, not connect with anybody, and time would just go by. But anyway,
flowers on the wall.
Yeah. Yeah. Just, doing nothing, staring at the wall, just letting time pass. Anyway, sorry, I got a little nervous too. But took years. It just kind of got worse and worse, I started going like a little nuts, going down like the conspiracy theory rabbit hole. Mm. And, as so many probably do. On the bright side of that, it did lead me to, your guys' show. But, I would lose, like, it was kind of weird. I would have, in private, when I was alone, I would have, like, no control over my, like, emotions. Like, I would think of things, and either it would just make me, feel terrible, or I'd watch something on TV, some suffering and some faraway country or whatever, and I would just burst into tears. But in social situations, I was totally cold. I felt like a sociopath. Like I had no, like I couldn't actually relate to people in any way, like anymore. Like I just totally wasn't even human anymore. It got so bad.
Yeah.
Sorry. What was that?
Oh, I'm just shocked by the story. So how has it changed for you? I mean, have you come out of the
absolutely,
shell?
Absolutely.
What happened?
Absolutely. It took a long time, but which is why I just wanted to try and share that story quick, because I know, especially myself, and I know anybody else in that same situation, you feel like, if you do take a moment to just look at, yourself from, you feel like it's just getting worse and worse, and there's no way out, and nothing you do changes anything. And, you know, it just seems like such an insurmountable issue because, you know, it's just this self-perpetuating thing. All these things just kind of get worse and worse. And anyway, myself, recently, you know, as I say, it did take years and years of you know, really trying hard to, you know, try to, like, kind of fix myself, I guess.
What was one of the techniques? I mean, when obviously you'd had a difficult time with people, but it was mostly self-imposed. You felt disconnected, separated from them. What did you do to change that?
Well, it's interesting because I think everybody always knows inside, like, what they need to do, you know, to you know, correct these, like, you know, issues or you know, like, they're just so afraid, right? So maybe they tell themselves for a while that, oh, that won't help or whatever the case may be. But you know in your heart that you have to just, like, in my case, you know, it was just, you know, forcing myself to just, like, go out and actually, like, interact with people. Because, I mean, as you guys, you know, I think it was Mark that mentioned earlier, just, you know, humans are social creatures, right? And, you know, even myself, where I was kind of introverted when I was younger, I didn't really feel I needed, you know, too much, like, social interaction, but it's just so incredibly important. Even just, like, a few words with somebody, you know, can slowly sort of get you out of that.
So what did you find yourself doing? I mean, what? Give me one example real quick of what you did differently to reacclimate yourself to start connecting with people again.
Well, I guess it also relates to one of the things that I lost, because I kind of was moving around from city to city. I would never stay in one place. And I was always I played music when I was younger, and that was kind of the thing I did, you know. So what I started doing was trying to get back into that and going online and finding people to just randomly, you know, on Craigslist or something, just finding people to jam with. And I found, you know, at least I didn't have to talk too much, you know, we could just meet and just play, you know, and let sort of the music sort of kind of break me out of my thing, you know?
Sounds like a good solution. Thanks for sharing your story tonight, Chris. I appreciate hearing from you. Just, you know, put some effort in and using the internet, something that some people say is disconnecting us from one another, using the internet as a tool to connect with other people you might not otherwise have met. I think that's pretty inspiring. 855-450-FREE, that's the toll-free number. You can bring up anything you want in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live, which are coming up next.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
Men who want intimacy and pleasure back in their love life don't ask if.
They ask when.
So men, spark up your love life, get pleasure and intimacy back, and please your special lady with Epic Nights. Epic Nights is a safe, revolutionary herbal sexual formula for men that combines ancient herbal ingredients and modern science to significantly support stamina, performance, and pleasure. Men, Epic Nights is a proven 100% natural product that works first time, every time,
even after consuming alcohol.
And you won't hear any of those cliche disclaimers, men, because Epic Nights will not give you unwanted side effects. But Epic Nights will allow you to give your partner what they deserve. Epic Nights is guaranteed as one of the most effective male enhancers on the web, or will refund your purchase 100%. Buy Epic Nights at buyepicnights.com, spelled BUYEPICNIGHTS.com. Or call 1-877-330-1120, 877-330-1120. Epic Nights. One pill.
One epic night.
Free Talk Live.
Are you saying there's something wrong with a gay couple adopting children?
Absolutely.
What could possibly be wrong about that?
then the children are going to be raised by queers instead of by, you know...
You are homophobic, aren't you, Tom?
No.
I think so.
But anyway...
What's wrong with them being raised by gay people?
Because gay people are unfit to raise children.
Oh, how dare you?
I object a lot. I had a friend who was adopted by gay parents, and he grew up just fine with completely normal values, and he's a very normal, functioning member of society.
I've met plenty of gay people in my time who I thought would make fantastic parents and would be far better parents than many of the white trash parents that are out there raising kids today. Tom, do you know any gay people?
I try not to, but...
Yeah, well, that figures. Dan, you're about done. Thanks for the call.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Did you know coffee is the second most absorbent crop on Earth? Most coffee at grocery stores and chains contains banned pesticides and has a high mold content. Seriously, we're proud to partner with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to provide the best of the best coffee, BuzzBox coffee. Try a free pound today. You cover shipping. 10% of future purchases benefit our efforts to give the gift of human freedom throughout the world. At least 100 World Vision microfinance loans. For more information, go to coffee.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain here, but enough time for your call and thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, Ian here.
And Brett.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy all the features that we share with you on the website. And if you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support what we're doing here, then please become a Free Talk Live amplifier. Your amp dollars that you contribute will be doubled thanks to our generous contributors, our matching contributors. And we've got the Bitcoin bonus available right now. You join as a Free Talk Live amplifier, say for $5 a month, you'll get that $5 back in Bitcoin. If you want it. Yeah, if you don't want it, we appreciate that too. But if you'd like the Bitcoin, just send me your Bitcoin address after you sign up for the AMP program in my email box to ian@freetalklive.com, and I will get you the Bitcoin back. So a little bonus incentive for you to sign up. Of course, there's other incentives like the fact that you get access to the AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only forum, the AMP-only Facebook group, which has also been a good thing for Free Talk Live. You were talking about the School Sucks Project one, Brett, as well. People love Facebook right now, and so we've got an AMP-only group that's been doing very well. You'll get access to that as well as a Free Talk Live amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com.
So is this the Bitcoin back bonus?
Sure.
Is the benevolent Bitcoin back bonus?
It doesn't seem malevolent, so sure. Interesting news, breaking news, according to the Free State Project Facebook group, Matt Phillips just posted in there earlier this evening about the New Hampshire Progressive Summit 2014 coming up in New Hampshire. There will be some sort of a gathering of liberals, lefties, progressives. They're all going to be coming together to talk about various different topics. There are a few topics that have been announced for this, and one of them is all about the Free State Project. Here's their description of what it is that they're going to be discussing. The Free State Project's stated purpose is to move to New Hampshire, take over the state government, and create a libertarian ideal of utopia. Nearly 15,000 libertarians have already signed a letter of intent to move and are expected to do so when the FSP hits a target goal of 20,000 signers.
Can these people not do math?
What are you confused about?
Well, I mean, there's 1.4 million people in the state of New Hampshire.
Yep.
How can 20,000 people move into a state of 1.4 million and take over? What's the percentage there, Brett? You're the genius. 0.0001%?
Wait a minute. You're supposed to be the genius. I wasn't prepared for that because when you're here, I take the night off.
I see.
But no, but I totally, I still think you're a genius, but I totally disagree with you here. I think you need far less people than that to have a major impact on the state. Now, taking a state over...
I don't think you're a genius anymore because you need far fewer people than that.
Right. What did I say?
Less.
Oh.
Unacceptable.
Good heavens. Far fewer is what I meant.
But I agree with you, Brett, that in this case, obviously 20,000 people aren't going to take over anything on their own. They'll have to influence people. They'll have to be active. They'll have to change people's hearts and minds. So there's a real task involved in this process. But nonetheless... they're afraid for a good reason, and I want to just let me share the rest of the description of what they're going to be talking about at the Progressive Summit June 7th at New England College in Henniker. They only have about five workshops. One, two, three, four. Yeah, five workshops are proposed. I believe this is a one-day event, so probably an all-day-long sort of thing. And one of these five is about the Free State Project. So they're saying that the Free State Project is going to move 20,000 libertarians. Granite State Progress and a working group of community members have tracked the influence and structure of the Free State Project over the years, from their attempts to slash public services to their vast social network that helps identify housing, jobs, and political opportunities for early movers. Come learn what it's about, how they operate, and what you can do to protect your community.
Yeah, Free Staters, once all 20,000 would move into the state, would be 0.014% of the population, which is probably about the percentage of Aborigines, Australian Aborigines that are in New Hampshire.
I think you're trying to distract from the real message here, Mark, and I think that what you're doing is not fair. The 20,000, and let's be realistic, it's not going to be 20,000. Some of those 20,000 are dead at this point. Some of them have forgotten they've signed up for the Free State Project. But let's just say 10,000 moves. You've still got more people, as far as activists are concerned. Probably with 10,000 people, you have more activists than the Republicans and Democrats do combined statewide.
I would say that we probably have as many activists currently as Republicans and as the Republicans or the Democrats. And honestly, many of the Republican activists were... liberty-oriented activists already. The Republican here's what my claim is: the Republican activists in the state are outnumbered, and the Democrat activists are equal to the Free State Project members activists.
I don't know if there's any truth to that statement. I mean, if that were true, if there were that many libertarian activists here, then we'd have candidates running in every race. And according to Daryl W. Perry, people being active as liberty-minded people. According to Daryl W. Perry, 43% of the state rep races are they're unchallenged. They're just incumbents running against no one. So obviously, there's a lot of room
for
activism.
They're very concentrated. Most Free State Project members live in Manchester. There are only so many house
seats. Most of them? I don't know if that's true either.
A good percentage of Free State Project.
A good percentage, sure.
So, are you willing to go half?
No way.
You willing to go 40%?
No.
30?
No. I would say there's no more than a couple hundred in the Manchester area.
All right. Well, they're not as spread out as you might imagine. For one, they tend to be in households. There's about 1,500 movers at this point. Many of those movers are spouses of movers who,
I don't want to get lost in the weeds on this. The reason I brought up this as an example here is that this sort of thing has never happened to libertarians.
No.
When has the Republicans or Democrats, the establishment party, ever had any kind of a presentation or a workshop in this case on the threat of the Libertarian Party? It's never happened because the Libertarian Party has never been a threat to any of the political establishments anywhere in the United States ever in its history. In its 40-year-long history, it's never been a threat. So there's never been a response like this. But the Free State Project has been called the single greatest threat to the state by one of the state representatives, who, by the way, is a part of this Granite State Progress group. They've formed a subgroup now called Our State Project. and that group will be opposing Free State Project candidates and attempting to out Free State Project candidates in this election season.
There's another aspect, too, and I agree with what you're saying, but there might be something else that's driving it. You said these are progressives, right?
This is their own claim. It's okay. The Progressive Summit.
Right, but that's also the language of progressives, that something, in order for them to justify their existence and their actions, something else is a threat. And it turns out everything is a threat because people are stupid and helpless, and that's why you need progressives in your life. So if it's funny how powerless some of the groups are that they claim they're defending you from. But this libertarian threat has been something that progressives are pushing now for years in some places. But because of what's going on in New Hampshire, I think that's contributing to its intensity.
Yeah, I mean, they're really scared. I mean, they know that something here is happening, and it's a real movement with a real influence. There's no, of the five different workshops they have, there's no workshop about how to deal with Republicans.
Right.
It's the libertarians that are the threat to the state. We're the ones who are the threat to the status quo. And so I think it's fascinating. It'll be interesting. Hopefully somebody will be able to attend this and, you know, sort of infiltrate, if you will, and sort of get the lay of the land for what their plan is. And that should be interesting to learn more about as time goes on. Let's go to David. He's in Kalamazoo. By the way, Free State Project, go to freestateproject.org. I brought that up as an excuse to tell you about the Free State Project, which is an idea of moving liberty-minded people to the same place and getting active. Obviously, it's already working because they are scared. David, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. You know, you're talking about competing against Republicans and Democrats as libertarians. I've known Michael Badnarik for a number of years, and before Michael was a libertarian candidate for the presidential candidate, we talked about what Bill Clinton did, which had never happened in this country. Do you know how the Republicans lost position? It was because Bill Clinton was able to mobilize a voting populace that had historically never voted. And he did that through promising benefits. And one of the issues that we as libertarians are dealing with politically is that we want to take our government back and take away benefits from people who are surviving on benefits. You're going to scare the dog mess out of Democrats. You're also going to scare the dog mess out of Republicans when you talk about releasing prisoners from prisons who have not committed crimes against other people.
Mm.
What we've got to do is stop trying to recruit Republicans and recruit Democrats. You got to go after the non-voting populace.
Yeah, I think that's true. Independents, at least here in New Hampshire, independents are the key to winning any election. I mean, the majority of voters in most places, as I understand it here in New Hampshire, are undeclared. They are neither Republican or Democrat. And thanks, David. I wish we had more time, but we're out of it for tonight. We'll be back tomorrow. You can join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com and check out schoolsucksproject.com for more of Brett. It's Free Talk Live.
We know you're out there. We can feel you now. We know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. We don't know the future. We aren't here to tell you how this is going to end. We're here to tell you how it's going to begin. We're going back to editing the next edition of Freedom's Phoenix Digital Magazine now, where we are telling the people what you don't want them to know. We're showing them a world without you, a world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries, a world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice we leave to you. Subscribe at freedomsphoenixeasy.com. That's freedoms with an S, phoenixeasy.com.
This is the Central Scrutinizer. I steal your labor by force through taxation.
My job is to spy on you and keep you from hearing things like the Freedom Fiends. I especially do not want you to
torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to keep them drone-proof. Do not go to freedomfiends.com and click on the torrent link and learn how to
torrent Fiends archives.
Do not go to freedomfiends.com
and click on the torrent
link and learn how to torrent Fiends archives. Do not go to freedomfiends.com
and click on the torrent link
and learn how to torrent Fiends archives.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, May 28th, 2014. Silver is trading at $19.10 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,266 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $568. Antiwar.com reports, Boko Haram has killed at least 54 people across northern Nigeria in multiple attacks over the past 24 hours, including a major raid in the Yobe town of Buniyadi. The Buniyadi attack started late Monday night with militants showing up in APCs and several pickup trucks, firing in the air until the military and police showed up and then killing 45 security personnel. In addition, multiple villages were attacked in the Nigerian state of Borno, as with past attacks, the Boko Haram fighters burned the villages to the ground, while most of the villagers managed to flee before the attacks started. Nine people were killed in the village attacks. Boko Haram raised white flags over the sites with Arabic lettering on them. Boko Haram has been increasingly active over the northern part of Nigeria over the past several months. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Washington Times reports Glenn Greenwald, one of the reporters who chronicled the document dump by NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden via the UK press, now said he's set to publish his most dramatic piece yet, the names of those in the United States targeted by the NSA. He told the Times of London, one of the big questions when it comes to domestic spying is, who have been the NSA's specific targets? Are they political critics and dissidents and activists? Are they genuinely people we'd regard as terrorists? What are the metrics and calculations that go into choosing those targets? And what is done with the surveillance that is conducted? Those are the kinds of questions I want to still answer. Greenwald also pointed to the failures of the NSA to catch Snowden during his download of 1.7 million documents and said that's further evidence of the government's inability to guarantee data security. There's this genuinely menacing spy system, and at the same time, they are really inept about how they operate it, he told Newsmax. Not only was he out there under their nose downloading huge amounts of documents without being detected, but to this day, they're incapable of finding out what he downloaded. Greenwald, who's promoting his new book, No Place to Hide, said the list will be published on his website, The Intercept, the site he established after leaving The Guardian. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports, President Barack Obama on Tuesday outlined a plan to withdraw all but 9,800 American troops from Afghanistan by the end of this year and pull out the rest by the end of 2021.